Hello.
What's up, everybody?
Hey, hey. I'm gonna do a quick shout out. We got Michael, we got Nosematics, we got Muck, we got La Serena, we got so many people in here today. Super excited to guys get going today. Big day. Maybe tell us what we got going on today.
Ooh, okay. We got Mimi Chan and the Nail Salon. She's gonna come on the stream, and we're gonna be talking about her art, her nail art, what she did for New Tokyo, her nail salon in New Tokyo, all that good stuff. Then we are gonna have a new segment today that we're very excited about, which is gonna be our own community Throwback Thursday. So we're gonna go through specific episodes of the past and go through Discord, the main characters that participated in those events and those episodes, and like just try to remember the good old days, right?
The good old days. I'm messing around with the background right here. We got some interesting choices today.
Nice.
I kind of like that one. Diamond, how are you today? I see. What's that shirt? Can you show us what you got going on there?
Sheesh. Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm just solid, just, you know, stretching out. Thursday, all that. You know, maybe rub a thimble real quick. See what's going on with the shirt, gang.
Oh, yo. Every damn Monday.
You know what it is. So just kicking it, you know, out here letting the mullet low, feeling good in this damn show tee. Ready to rock with the homies. Y'all know what it is. I see a fake guy noticed the mustache with a little new facial style right now here. My wife absolutely can't stand the soul patch. I'm like on a double negative right now with the bullet. She calls this the bowl cut mullet. It's called the bullet. And then I got this soul patch that she despises so heavily, right? And so like just know that if I don't make it into the stream on Sunday, like, my wife has some information for you, okay? That's what I'll say, all right? But no, getting ready for a fresh haircut. It's time. You know, what the lady wants, the lady gets. So one way or the other, something's got to go right now, unfortunately. But I'm feeling pretty degenerate myself, feeling pretty good, ready to rock on a Thursday. Let's get it going, y'all.
Look, Diamond, if one thing had to go, if it was the mullet or the mustache, then you gotta keep the mullet. Mustache has got to go.
Yeah, that's my thing. I'm gonna try to grow this out to like a little bit of a handlebar here, but like the soul patch, that's what has to go. Like, you can't
save that for November.
Like, it roughs me up every time I come in for a kiss. I'm tired of it. It's gotta go. And I'm like, it's only been here for like 2 days. Come on, baby, give it a chance. It's a vibe, you know.
Hey, you know what? You're allowed to do that in November. So wait 2 weeks and then you're allowed, because it's for men's health. And if she's like, no mustaches, you're going to be like, what? You don't give a shit about men's health? That's kind of fucked up. So
that's a weak excuse.
Are you kidding me? You don't like men's health? Maybe that's really fucked up. Wow.
That's fire true. Right now. What is going on with our background? It's extravagant. It's next level. I mean, we're rolling through levels right now. I'm loving it.
I see we got Crazy Carl in the chat. Carl, look, justice for Carl. We still want to have a trial for you. We think you're innocent, for the record. It's the proceedings are still ongoing, and Spike has been pretty silent. I think he's on the run. I think he's headed to Mexico or like Venezuela because he's afraid of the Fed. So just know that you got the momentum on your side, and Carl's are going to, they're going to be all right. That's all I'm going to say. Packard appreciating the sweater. Thank you. Thank you. And he's also appreciating Diamond's mustache. Maybe let's see that sweater that you got going on, because I think that needs some love as well.
Regina,
baby.
Regina rules.
She's out here. She is freaking out here. Okay, so let's just run through really quickly. We have, first of all, we have an OG content creator, Mimi Chan, with those fire ass nails. So we're excited to finally get her on and put a face and voice to whoever this mysterious nail wizard is. So I'm excited for that. Then we can't ignore what the past few days. We got to talk about Kagami. We got to talk about the drama. We got to talk about the mint, and we're going to go through all of it. And then maybe we have an exciting segment. I'm so excited for this. And we have a little intro video and an overlay as well. I'm so excited. I want to get to it right now. I just want to play the video, but we're not going to. We're going to wait until it's time for Throwback Thursday on the Dam. And one thing I want to let everybody know, when we're going through that segment, if you have a cool memory from a year ago, tweet it out and we will get it on the show. Just tag the Dam Show and put a little hashtag TBT on Dam, and we're going to get that all out there as well. But save that for the segment. When is Mimi Chan expected to make an arrival?
In about 47 minutes, 48 minutes.
Amazing. Okay. So she's coming at the top of the hour. So why don't we get started with, I mean, I think it's the elephant in the room.
Yeah.
Let's get started with. Oh, okay. Let me get the background set for this one.
Let's say hello to Discord.
Let's say hello to Discord. Yeah, before we jump in. Okay. Let's go to Discord. Maybe, do you want to take the lead on today's Discord jumping? Or shall I? It's up to you.
Okay. Right now I can do it. I just need a little help for the Throwback Thursday, because the list that I created, it doesn't let me jump straight to Discord, the app, but it goes on my browser, and it doesn't work correctly for me. When I click on the link, it doesn't go to the app, it goes to the browser, and it's not good.
You know what you need to do, maybe? You know what you need to do? You need to take that list and paste that into a Discord room. So go to the server that you have and paste that whole list in there, because when you put it in there and you click the link, it'll take you right to the message. So that's the issue, because it's out of app.
And now it's gonna be.
We got Philly up in here.
I hope it's going to be
top shot. I'm still thinking about the conversation that we had in New York. Definitely 100%.
Yes, top shot.
The dam to Philadelphia.
Yes. I want to take a train. I haven't took a train yet, like outside of New York, and I can't wait. I don't know why. I'm super excited to travel by train, and I want to travel to Philly by train. So
it's fun.
It's gonna happen.
We got Thug Punjabi. You got Dace J. Yo, Dace, congratulations once again, Mr. 416, on the win a few weeks ago. You won one of the San NFTs that we gave away on the damn show. So congratulations. Diamond, I feel like we have a bunch of new people in this chat. So do you want to show off some of the t-shirts, and maybe can we reveal? Oh, okay. We're in.
Yeah, we can just put it later. Let me know.
I was going to say, can we reveal that one of the goodies that we were supposed to have, but we got rugged, and Diamond is wearing it right now. Can we reveal that on stream?
Let's reveal that.
Yeah. So, okay. Just to set it up, at the New York 10KTF birthday event, we had coffee mugs. We had some beans, which, by the way, you can still go and purchase right now. They're only going to be available for a few more, I would say at least one more week. So check that out on the damn dot show. But along that, we also had t-shirts to give out for everybody, but we got super rugged with it. Didn't show up on time, but Diamond is wearing one of them right now. Team Atari. I appreciate
you. I'm thirsty. I'm just thirsty, I swear.
That's the first time that I've seen that mug. Maybe, you know, I left that in New York. I forgot mine at your spot or at the Airbnb I was staying at. But it's okay because look, I'm traveling a lot.
I don't have it.
Yeah. So I'm traveling a lot. And so it would also just be very difficult for me to move around with all these things without it breaking. And so I feel like I left a present for the person that hosted the Airbnb. He has a Team Atari mug now that he can drink out of. Diamond, go ahead and show everybody the t-shirts that everybody was supposed to get, but we got rugged.
All right, y'all. So what we got here is a damn white tee, right? It's just a standard white tee, damn show on the corner here. I live in the middle of nowhere. So gotta get my, let me pull my mullet back for a second, right? Clean damn logo. Oh, clean damn logo right here, upper left, right? Then you flip it around. Better pull the party to the front.
Yo.
Every damn Monday, y'all. Y'all know what it is.
Yeah.
Coming to you every week. And so, just the fit and feel of them wasn't exactly, I guess Netta wanted them just a little bit tighter for our folks. You know what I'm saying? But y'all know, hey, I'm a degen. My mullet don't care about scratchy feel or none of that. And so, like, y'all, I'm with this 100%. I'm rocking it around my little town. I'm hoping someone will ask me, hey, what's the damn show? And I could like just break them off and be like, oh, I do a YouTube show with a couple degens. Like, you should check it out sometime. You know, I'm hyped.
Diamond, you also got your damn coffee beans. Do you want to show them off? Maybe. I think you have them as well.
Yeah.
Okay. I think I'm still waiting on mine. No. So, okay. I say that and they both leave once again for me to just, okay. Hey, everybody. So we got Atari's Power Hour over here. While they go get and hunt some beans, we're going to talk about Diamond's. Oh, she's back. Okay. We're going to talk about Diamond's background, but it's a good bag of beans right there. A damn good bag of beans. I feel like I have to
so just good. Pop up these. Oh my god! Boom. I just want to drink this coffee all day. It smells too good. Too good.
Okay, so prism. Diamond. Okay, Diamond, you got this. Is the present that Bugsy Van, and I'm seeing Van later today. By the way, we're getting dinner with Nano Van somewhere here. In this undisclosed location that everybody knows of now.
But, yeah, did you get this as well?
I mean,
Diamond, you got this as well?
Me?
Yeah, I did. Did you get the beans or the ground?
I got the ground. I already have the beans. I have the beans in the sample.
Yeah. I got the ground too, and then yeah, got the beans in the sample here. Got the one sample, and then got my ground here ready to roll. Didn't bust it open this morning. Jade was asking about it, and I'm like, you know what? We are gonna rip this thing open. We might need one more bag. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Uh, just because, I don't know, it's pretty incredible. Like I was, I told them in the chat, like, y'all know, I don't know, if you haven't gotten to know me yet, I'm a super simple like type of dude. I mean, I need my basketball, my bong, and my friends, and I'm good to go wherever I go. You know what I'm saying? And so, like, I don't know, like, to, like, get this little trophy, like, to like, I don't know, some of the gifts and just the love that's been shown along this journey, like, it is freaking incredible, y'all. And I'm seriously mind blown. This is, like, to have my fucking face on a fucking item that's, like, at the market right now, like, this is so far from anything that I could conceptualize 12 months ago, you know? And to watch the damn show grow as fast as it has in the last 3 months and be able to create content with friends and have friends supporting that along the journey, it's mind-blowing to me. It is seriously... I don't know what the fuck is going on in Web3, but like it's pretty awesome. And I don't know, for me, I just want to say thank you to everybody. It's been amazing, for real.
Plus, we also have some fun introductions. I want to play this one again because I love it so much. It's
Yeah, our new intro.
Do you remember a few weeks ago when we would get rugged every time we played a video? And now that we don't, I love playing these videos. We got the coffee out of the way, and thank you to everybody that has bought so far, and we're hearing some good reviews.
Yeah, thank you, guys.
It's a smooth blend, so tri-blend. Let's get into the items. So now we can finally talk about it, now that Diamond has got the gifts that we got at the NFT NYC event from Van, Merlin, Kent, and Bugsy. And some of the names there were like, I didn't do anything, but like we still gave everybody credit. Okay, thank you. There's a card. I didn't get everything on me, but I do have some of the stuff with me because I have a small backpack. We got a Captain Mibinetta card. Can you show that box that you have, maybe? It's the funniest, like, Chinese takeout, but it's also like a backpack, or not a backpack, but like a little purse.
It's like a lunch box.
Yeah.
And it's nice because it's like a Japanese theme, and it says thank you, which is super sweet. Like, I don't know. It's so sweet. Thank you for what? Thank you, guys. You got your stuff, Diamond. And I'm going to try to take it out. Oh, no, wait. I have the card also. The card was super cute as well. We got cats with, like, I don't know, some, like, I don't know if it's Japanese, this as well.
It kind of looks, to be honest, somebody honest would know more, but it doesn't.
Yeah, guys, do you recognize it?
It doesn't look Japanese, but what do I know?
And this was super sweet.
I got a hat. Bugsy got me the funniest hat. Tell me if it's backwards or not. I have to wear this on stream.
Hey, that's a trucker special if I've never seen one before, man. That's a winner right there. Dang.
Hot as hell, cold as ice. Thank you for this hat. It's the funniest thing. I'm getting a lot of. I'm in a WeWork right now, and everybody's just looking at this hat right now. So it's a great hat. Thank you. And then we also got this. We got some.
We all got cats. Like, this is the
cat socks.
These are amazing.
I get such Christmas vibes from this. I'm excited for the Christmas episode.
This is gonna happen then. Like, I don't know how comfortable this is.
It's all right. Hey, I'm gonna need you to edit this out later, man. But hey, my feet are jacked up, y'all. Like,
Diamond, we're on live.
Bro,
that's for OnlyFans afterwards.
Like, take my feet off. You know there's some foot people out there, bro. You gotta edit my foot out of the screen, man. Come on, we haven't talked about this. Like, edit them out.
We just got a spike in viewers.
I don't know where this is supposed to split at. You know, where, like, I don't know where my feet are supposed to go. My wife literally said, like, with feet like yours, like, do you know what are going to happen to those socks if you try to wear them? And I'm like, hey, still rocking them on a run. No, check this out. They're ninja socks.
By the way, this looks a lot like a Wagmi Scout. They're not like
to 100%. Brag, but
like this looks a lot like that.
Diamond, watch out. We got some moderators from YouTube are looking at it. They're like, whoa, we just saw a massive spike in viewers and we got some sensual feet on the camera, so not good.
I will shut down the only feet. I will shut down the only feet right now. Okay? No more feet, I promise you.
Diamond feet.
Well, I thought you
could. That's the comment of the night so far.
Thank you. We needed that.
That's the comment of the night. Oh my god, diamond feet. That's hilarious. With the fucking emojis too. Oh my god, look at that. It's one thing, you gotta put the diamond and then the feet, but it's okay. Oh, that's funny. Okay, yeah, so thank you everybody to if you haven't subscribed, by the way, please subscribe. We just gained some followers. We got a trophy, best manager as well. I have one as well, so those are incredible. I'm seeing some really
special item per person.
Yes.
I showed you mine.
Yeah.
That's your special. It was only for Atare. Then Diamond, what was your special item? There's one that only you got.
I got some links. Hang on. Hold up.
What is it? Wasn't it like
he was just wearing it.
Wasn't it a necklace?
Yeah, yeah. He was just
I don't know what it was. I'm gonna show my special item.
I forgot what you got, maybe.
Guys, this is very functional because I can actually, you know, it's not just, you know, just a pineapple. I can actually put, you know, some change in here and bring it with me. Yeah, you see. What is that?
They're like links. Little necklace links. Oh, and this.
Oh, cool.
The energy.
Yeah, that's the diamond. Yeah.
No, the big diamond. Okay, yeah. Wife is like, oh, that's a... Like, we're going to hang that in the office. It'll, like, spin, and it'll be like, when the light hits it, babe, it's going to create a prism. And I'm like, oh, awesome, baby. Yeah, we're going to party, you know.
Did you see mine, Diamond?
And then I got this, too.
What's that? Ah, the nose. I saw that you showed it last week.
My nose is huge, so don't exactly fit, but, you know. What were you saying? Sam, what'd you get, Netta? What's an apple you got there?
Oh my god, but it's functional. I was saying that I can, you know, actually use it for, you know, bring stuff with me. So yeah.
Okay, that's what I was gonna ask. What would you put in? Yeah, what would you put inside? It's like a little coin purse.
What is it for? Probably change.
Reminds me of an OG coin purse. You know, the ones that used to like have that little flap on them. I don't know if y'all remember. Maybe I'm aging myself right now. No, but...
like the ones that you open like this and then. Yeah, of course. Yeah. Grandma had like a million of those.
Oh, thanks. No.
Yeah, shout out to the nose for the nose. Like, I can't believe we got silver nose.
I was not live last week when they showed the video, but I want to say thank you again. I think you saw how happy we were when we actually we shared the moment of opening the box that I received. So thank you so much. It did look amazing.
Hey, y'all. I got home last night and there were two boxes, huge box waiting on my front porch and then a little box sitting next to it. And like me and my wife are like dancing in the living room. Like, how fucking cool is this? I don't know. It's just something that I would never expected, you know, a year ago. So just to have a room to celebrate last night was freaking amazing.
Yeah, I'm still waiting on my silver nose to arrive.
I didn't ship it to you. I will ship it to you. I'm going to give it to you. You wait for it. Sorry. Like, do you really need it now?
No, you're right. I think
Art basil, okay.
Yeah. No, you're right. We agreed to that. I thought that you had shipped it to me, but I had said, hey, don't ship it. I'll get it to you at Art Basil. You're right. Okay. We're good. We're clear. I thought she was playing favorites by shipping it to Diamond only. The nerve.
Hey, and then shout out to 4-9's silver, the number 4, and then NINES, right? I know, like, that's like they do custom silver, right? That's how we got these nose. Nose told me about who did the noses themselves, and so I just wanted to give a shout out back to the original creator. Always important to give credit for that type of stuff. Thank you, Nose. We appreciate it a bunch, man.
Yeah, I'm so curious for the nose branding, like Nosematics, username Nose. He's got a nose as a PFP, and then the silver noses. Like, there's a whole damn nose brand going on. He puts noses on each of the messages as well. That's like your default. I'm like, I like what you got going on, Nosematics. It's a whole ass brand.
He knows what's up. That's right, Matt.
He knows. Let's go, Matt. No. Let's go. You're going to enjoy it. It's an amazing tri blend. A lot of people have started receiving it, and they were getting some good reviews. So we hope you enjoy it, and let us know what you think.
All right. Sorry about that shipping cost on there, too. We're still working on getting the shipping costs. We're on the next round. I'm going to have to strong arm these motherfuckers at UPS one time. I'll tell you what, you know.
We're going to pull them into a back room and be like, all right, explain what the hell's going on here. What is this?
Yeah. Global supply. Let's talk about this, all right? Because the damn coffee needs to get out to the people.
to the damn people. To the degens all over the world.
The captain's brew. Maybe let's pull up your Discord and...
Yeah, okay.
We also got to talk about... After this... Let's talk about it. Also, zoom in if you can.
We are live on the down.
Maybe do the trick that you told me. Command plus.
But you know that it doesn't work on mine.
Really?
I told you. Oh, no, wait. Okay, sorry. Because I was trying the other day and it didn't work. Hello, what's happening? Can you see it?
Yeah.
Can you see it or bigger?
That's good, actually.
Okay,
that's perfect.
Let me write
your partner, the SEC.
Ciao, mamma. Sono su Zam Show. So the pasta today is pretty... you know, focus on mirrors for some reason. I don't know.
I have no idea what that would be about.
Yeah, why mirrors specifically, but...
I have no idea what that's about. Diamond, do you know why everybody's talking about mirrors on the wall? What's going on in 10KTF?
Oh, I don't know, man. It's something about... if you look up the Japanese word for mirror, I heard that... Mm-hmm. You may find out some sort of a clue leading to a possibility of some type of a mint something later today. I don't really know.
Interesting.
Not sure, but I'm pretty sure if you look up the Japanese word for mirror, it'll have some insight for you. Some sleuthing you might have to do there.
Very interesting. So,
you want to set it up? We gotta talk about it. Let's set it up. We're talking about
We're talking Kagami. Okay, Kagami. So what's happened?
This is the
what happened this week. We had to register for a raffle, and we thought that not so many people were actually registering, because, like, I remember what I said on the damn episode. I was like, imagine the team now looking at us, laughing at us, like, haha, guys, you're really thinking, like, there is not even enough people registering for the Kagami, for the amount of Kagamis, right? Mm-hmm. I said something like that, which shows all of you how clueless I was about the rough, like how many people register or like, it surprised me. I wasn't expecting that. I was expecting, yes, maybe like some people, like to the worst thing possible for me, the worst percentages was gonna be like 50%. Like, you know, flip of a coin, like Altara said, but it felt mm-hmm. like it was not like that. I don't know, to be honest, if it was 50% or less. I don't know if we have any data on that, but many people didn't get it.
Yeah, I don't have any data. I tried, honestly, figuring out how many people could have theoretically gotten 10 badges, and the number for that is honestly just as much as it's about 7,500, which is about the number of holders that were there in general. Like, it's how many holders we have right now. Excuse me. So it hasn't really changed that much. So that's that. I'm going to turn this off for a second. So yeah, I saw a lot of people, a lot of OGs didn't get it. Some people got it, some people didn't. And then I think we also want to talk about, I think, some of the reactions in the Discord, because I would say that it was fairly, like, I don't know, like, it was kind of toxic is it for sometimes in terms of just the way that I think the energy was being, I think, communicated, because I think people would be like, oh my god, I got it, and then I would see people respond back like, nobody cares, and like very like harsh like messages. And so that was, I think, very jarring, just to see how it all played out.
Yeah, y'all know I don't go in the Discord very much anymore, right? Like, it is what it is. Like, I'm not shy about that. Like, it's just hard for me to go in there and commit to, like, I don't know. Moral of the story is like, I did go in and I peeked at some of the messages that were going on in the last few days, and kind of the nature of the chat. And, you know, it's been a while. I'm not really super familiar with the tone, but like, compared to what it was a year ago, seems to take a shift, you know. And I understand people that are frustrated. The people that seem to be most frustrated that I see are the people that have been creating content, been holding it down for Wagmi the longest. Right, like really working for 10K TF or Wagmi, you know, because some of us have been doing that, whether we want to acknowledge it or not, right? And so I totally understand that some people are frustrated, some people are hurt even. Like, let's take it to that next level. For as much as we love Wagmi, some people are hurt, you know? But to see some of that energy kind of shift away to this, like, oh, we can't celebrate other people's wins because I'm missing out now. You know, I acknowledge wholeheartedly, you know, I've been in this since day one. I've been gifted a lot of shit on this journey. I've never missed out on a team gift, right? And this mint was something different. But like, I don't know, I reflect back to when the tools and materials got distributed. You know, no one was super upset because anyone got extra tools, or you know, we all donated that. We basically deflated the cost of the tools in front of the team, in front of everybody, right? And people were fucking concerned, right? But we had to trust in this larger ethos and this longer vision, vision, right? This isn't about this one particular moment. Even though it feels some type of way, I mean, I didn't get any tools back then. I just had all commons, and I think rares and epics were the ones that got considered for tools. Right. And so like there's different levels to the game. But there's also been like, I felt like a couple, like, I don't know, like people are thinking that like there might have been like cheating in the pre-mint. And when we get to that level and we start like speculating that the team is rigging fairness on the backside, We get into a place where it's like, what the fuck is going on here, y'all? Just going to be flat.
Just like, to, like, I want to jump in here.
Yeah, please. I mean, I love everything we've done, but like, it just seems to like the tone, maybe it's the status of the larger market, Atari. I don't know, but the tone just seems to have shifted a little bit, right? And I want to be empathetic and I want to be, you know, solid through this, but like, it just seems that we've kind of peeled away from the origins of WAGME, you know. Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, no, you're good. So there's a couple things I wanted to, I think, address. First is the first night that we got it, I had been away from the Discord for at least a few days, just honestly really focusing on the damn show content, whatever. And so when you want to do that, it's like spending too much time in Discord in general tends to like shift away your focus or your ability to create cool content or think about cool content. And so because you're kind of, when you're on Discord, you're always reactive, you're reacting to messages, you're, you know, things are, so it's like I wasn't really into it. But generally, when I took a peek over the past few days when the Kagami raffle was announced, I didn't see that much excitement. And I'm like, okay, people aren't that jacked up about this. It's a cool mirror, it's going to be a fun thing, but that's about it. And so when the mirror, when the raffle results came out, and I was on it, for me, I went back into that same character. I want to be very clear. It was a character that I was playing that that was when I lost the 7 badge. When I only had 7 badges and I didn't get the extra crate that everybody else that had 8 badges got. For me, that was, I'll be honest, I didn't like that. I felt like I missed out. I felt like that wasn't fair. But for me, the way that I wanted to, I think, voice my displeasure of that was to make a campaign out of it and make it fun. It's like, okay, there's a bunch of 7 badgers and there's all these 8 badgers, and the 8 badgers feel like, in a sense, better. And so I'm like, okay, well, how do I play this in a way where it's fun, but I also communicate my message of like, I'm not happy. I'm like, I'm going to become the leaders of the 7 badgers. And I'm going to fight for this cause. And there was pasta for days. I got railed on by people. I got made fun of. There's a lot of that. But I took it in stride because I'm like, one, it's fun. And two, I think if there was ever going to chance for it to change, it was like, this is how I think I could do it. It didn't happen. Okay, cool. And so when I won the raffle for the Kagami, I went back into that character of like 7 badgers have risen, because I saw some other 7 badgers that also won the Kagami. And so for me, it was like playing into that same character again. And I think for me, there was a tone shift, or I didn't read the room fully, because people were actually legitimately like deeply angry. They were not happy. And I mean, that's where what you said, that started getting into this whole idea of like people insinuating or right, saying that it was rigged. It's like, oh, of course all the captains got it. And that's such a, I think if you understand pre-mint, you understand that technically that's not possible. Go talk to the creators of it. There, you can DM them, you can ask them. That's not how it works. And I think the voice, my perspective that I kept bringing to the Discord wasn't that don't complain about this. It was two things. One, you complain about it, you're not feeling good about it. Okay, it's fair. People should feel what they feel. But when you start crossing a specific line and you start, I think, being quite frankly toxic in some of the complaints and some of the insinuations, that's where you have to draw a line and place a boundary and say, that's not appropriate, that's not okay. And the second thing is that after a bunch of days of complaining or voicing your displeasure, it's like you have to also ask yourself, we all share this room. Grilled is everybody's room. And so how is it fair for everybody else that wants to move on or not want to talk about it, for somebody to come in and constantly harp on the same thing again and again and again? And I think at that point, it's like, you can say, well, nobody, if you don't want to talk about it, don't talk about it. But when a very, I think, when a topic like that comes in, it becomes the dominant rhetoric. And that brings down the energy of the room. And it's like, for some people, they wanted to move on, whether they won or they didn't win. And so, my goal for this was always to just like, okay, you're not happy, I get that, it could have been done better in your opinion, that's fair, but how many more days are we going to continue this and then again start throwing, I think, dirt at people? Because that's not a fair thing. That's like, that's not cool in general. And it's like, there has to be some boundaries to that. There are rules to the game, and it's like, it's not a good look. And so that's my piece on it. Those are my internal feelings. And I'm sure everybody can say, well, it's easy for you to say because you won. And it's like, you know what? Well, I didn't win the free crate, and it was about $1,000. It's about the same price as this, if you want to make it about monetary terms. And it's like, you know, I took that energy and I tried to channel that in a way that I felt so was productive, but still got my message across of like, I want a damn free crate, because I don't think it's fair that seven badgers for people that missed out because they're halfway across the world. And I wasn't halfway across the world, but still a lot of people were. They missed out on a mission and they, you know, didn't get rewarded for that. So I feel like there's a lot of similar tones here, but just how this all unfolded to me was very jarring. And that 1 hour where we had all the OGs jump into the room at night and really just bring the vibes back was incredible. That was, I felt so refreshed and so good about that.
Yeah. And that's what made us understand also how powerful is the energy. Like when we're all, when we go back to the past and we think about the past, like that's why history is important. And even if we have a short history in 10KTF, it's still important because in NFTs 1 year ago, it's not 1 year ago. We all know it. It feels like, you know, everything is much longer. Like 1 year ago, it was another world. We were a different people. Like, I mean, with the understanding that we had about the space, I didn't know anything 1 year ago. I was, you know, just jumping into this craziness. Like, it's not that I know much more now, but a bit more, yes. Anyway, that made us also think about, it's important to celebrate the past, also things that happened, also show how we reacted to things in the past, how we experienced things in the past. And it was like one of the reasons why we decided also to start a new segment in the show, because it makes complete sense to go back and see, okay, so what happened 1 year ago? How was the community reacting to this specific thing? Were we celebrating? Were we angry? How did it play out? If we were angry, how long did it last? Like, was it really necessary to be so angry, like going back, right? Because it's always important to also reflect on things, especially us, that we take care of the community, we care about the community, and that's all community feelings, community emotions, all that happened, and that's what we do at the dam. So I think it's gonna be interesting to go through those episodes and see. And in 1 year from now, we're gonna talk about this moment, and we're gonna be 1 year ago it was crazy how the Kagami's situation went down, but anyway,
for me, yeah, I think a couple good points that were made, Mute put down there, said, think distribution is an important signal to show that everyone in 10K Friends has a chance at cool stuff, not only OG whales. In the end, they take care of everyone who takes part, right? And so, like, it's a beautiful, like, homage to like folks that have participated for 10 badges, right? But like, who I see most frustrated by this is like I said, I mean, it's the people that have been in who've been doing community work for some time, right? And I think the point about OG whales, right? So like, some of us aren't whales in necessarily holder status. We're whales in the time that we put into this project, like the dedication, that the time we put in for the larger ethos for the community, right? So like, whales can be coming in different sections, but like, for us that have been creating at the community level, like, there's no, like, we're working to hopefully build into the future for some future opportunity for ourselves, but there's not like anything on the team's end of them taking care of creators in this, right? I'm hopeful for that day. We've all put in a lot of work, right? And I think we're getting to the point where I'm hopeful that the team is getting ready to step up. That's what I thought 10kfriends.org might have been for, is to try to get an alternative route to provide for our content creators. But the reason why I quit 6 months ago doing all this, y'all, is because I'm having a hard time putting food on my fucking table, right? Mm-hmm. Like, and it shouldn't be like that. You shouldn't have to put in this much work into a project for a community, for the larger ethos, and then wonder how you're going to pay bills as they're bringing in multi-millions of dollars. And so for our creators' end, I'm looking forward to the day, hopefully, where the team can start to recognize us for what we do and provide some sort of value to that, right? I don't think they're being super creative about getting creatives paid right now, unfortunately. And I know a lot of us have put in a lot of time. We all have our own opportunities into the future, so I don't want to be too heavy. This is all decentralized, right? But I think it's something that some of us on the creators end have been thinking about for some time. for whatever it's worth, right? And so to see the content creator side especially be like, I'm being left out in the cold. It's just like, damn, like, I get it. I understand how you feel that way, homeboy, homegirl.
I wanted to jump in, and I think it's, you have to also keep perspective on who has, what have we got? Because sometimes you can get into a space of, I want the next thing, but you forget about what you have gotten so far. And so let's wind it back. We're doing an almost mini Throwback Thursday segment here, because I think that's part of the inspiration behind the segment that we're going to do after the Mimi Chan interview, because it's always good to keep stock and be grateful. So OGs from way back a year ago, we all got a tools airdrop. And that's one of the comments that I made in the Discord a couple of days ago, where I said that some people think that the Kagamis are more consequential than the tools airdrop. And I'm like, I completely disagree fundamentally, because there was so much more money on the line for the tools airdrop. Thimbles are approximately 5K. Some people got three tapes and they just got lucky. And at that time, they weren't able to, you weren't able to craft if you didn't have tools. That is fundamentally way more impactful in the storyline, in terms of the NFTs, in terms of the ROI, whatever you want to, however you want to play it. It was so much more impactful. But, and there was frustration, of course. But then in the converse of that, the frustration of sharing was that I bought these tools with my own hard-earned ETH. And now, because you guys are all sharing, it's devaluing the tools floor price. And that's exactly what happened. But we as a community banded together and we moved through that. And the team recognized that and then found other utility for the tools. And so it's like, we there's a tools airdrop. Then let's keep going. We had the Gucci airdrop that a bunch of OGs got for free as well. Then you had the original 10K Friends Ape airdrop, which happened in August, that a bunch of people got. And so therefore their level 2 combat tools were effectively by and large for free, depending on how many NFTs you had. And so then this raffle is for people that had 10 badges. And if you do the math, around the time the combat sale started until now, it gets you approximately 10 badges. And so this was now equal footing for everybody. To me, I'm like, if I didn't get it, I'd be like, okay. And if I really want it, I'm going to have to pay a bit of a premium on the aftermarket. Maybe if I time it right, I can snipe it when, you know, the attention for it dies down and I can get it for cheap. I thought that was fair. It's because if this then also only goes to people that have been OGs and have extra weight and whatever, then it's like, then you're saying that this project will not reward you if you join right now. It's not worth it. Just move on. That's what it's signaling, because in the past there's been so many things that have been given to people that have joined earlier than later. That's just the fundamental nature of it. And so, yeah, I really think that it's good to keep stock and be grateful of just everything. For me, it's not just the NFTs and the money and whatever. It's also just friendships. It's a community. It's you two. It's being able to build a show. So for me, I'm like, if I lost the Kagami raffle, I'm like, okay, I lost the Kagami raffle. I'm not going to be happy about it. Just like I wasn't happy about the Coda. I really wanted a Coda so fucking bad, like deeply. I had to have it.
Yeah.
And I lost and it sucked, but I was always like, okay, like let's process this and let's get back to it. When you get punched and you get knocked down, what's there to do? It's to get back up. That's it. Right. And so.
And I hope I didn't come off as ungrateful at all, y'all. I'm super fucking grateful. No, you're good. Right. For all the blessings and everything. It's just, I'm also like thinking outwards, thinking into what the future looks like too. And just want to be sure, you know, everyone's being looked after, you know. I've been gifted so much along this journey. I'm so humbled and so grateful as well. Even to the point where us as the damn show, we even got some social value as far as like being made the captains, right? Like that's a big deal. So the team is trying to show us value in different ways too, but like just for everybody, you know, for the WAGMI, for the one time. But I do look back to when they shifted to PFPs only in participation, and like it felt different that day for a lot of us too, right? And so I think that this is one other lens of this, them kind of showing us, hey, y'all, there are going to be different tiered opportunities moving into season two, right? But I think that as long as we know what being a true fan is, as long as we know how true fans get rewarded, right? Because like you said, Atari, there's been a bunch of rewards for all of us along this journey too, right? I don't get my WoW. I don't get my wizard. I don't get these things that I couldn't have dreamed of before without the blessings TF and the fam that I've been kicking it with, right? All my friends I've got to know along the journey. So I think that's a great point, man. I hope I didn't come off as ungrateful or anything like that.
That wasn't in response to you at all. That was just okay, in general. Cool. No, you're good. So. That was just the point that I had it queued up in my mind. No, you're good.
Hey, I tried on these damn toes are back, y'all. Gotta show y'all. Toes are back right now. For the first time. All right, let's get toesy again. All right. Hey, I don't know if this is the first time I've ever tried these type of socks, y'all, and I can't stop doing this. Like, I can't fucking stop flicking the big toe in those. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. Have you ever worn toe socks before? You guys do the same thing? It's fucking crazy. All I want to do is just flick my toes right now.
Bugsy, you did this.
Maybe that's all I want to do.
Oh my God. Yeah.
All
like,
I want to do is have fun. And I got a feeling I'm not the only one. You know what I'm saying? What's up, BMW?
Hi, Ben.
What up, Ben? What up, Robo? What up, Nose? What up, Fitz?
Yeah, so
Fitz is saying, I didn't get the Kagami raffle, but super happy for those that were lucky enough. Humility and grace. Let's not get too entitled. Absolutely. 1,000%. And I want to be very clear. At no point do I want to feel like the three of us, we will stray at times. We will make mistakes. We will feel entitled. I made a mistake by being too like 7-badge, 8-badge energy at a time that it wasn't, it wasn't welcoming the community. People weren't ready for that, or people didn't want that by me being antagonistic, about like winning. And I own that. That's fair. I will own that. And I take that in and I learn, a lesson from that. So it's not like we're saying we're all so perfect that we are never entitled and we are not this and everybody else should be. It's like, no, we will stray as well. And we will make mistakes as well, and that's okay. I think that's part of being human. It's being able to be, like Fitz says, being humble enough or having humility to recognize when you have erred, and to say, yeah, you know what, that was me. I own that. That's fair, and that's okay. I'm human, and I'm still here. And what we do with the dam, what we said in the first week was about the show. It's better every day. But I think as an ethos of just the three of us. Everybody, it's like, let's be better every day. Let's get better every day. And I think if you can do that, if you can do 1% better every day, you're onto something.
Yeah.
And like Ben just said, I mean, we can't all make it unless we make it together, right? And we know that that's a platitude, right? That's the feel good thing, right? In the middle of a bear market, that's the shit that feels good. But I think we've learned over this last year that there's also truth in that. Right. We've seen the way that people, you may get your opportunity, but you're not leaving anyone else behind. Right. We're always looking out for other people. And I think that was, we saw some threads, some people trying to look out for OGs like, hey, y'all, if you're an OG and you didn't get a badge, a Kagami, you know, hit me up. Let's see if we can work some things out. I think Dilly was working on a thread trying to hook people up. Right. And we've seen folks like through the genuine spirit of WAGMI looking back to when we were sharing tools. And materials. Diamond, try to carry that spirit forth of looking out for each other. Yeah, please.
I was going to add to what you were saying, and then you can please continue. But Polaris also started a thread in Discord so that people could share or say, "Hey, I'm not minting." If somebody says spot, like, go ahead and like. And I think it's important to do it also in like a open spot because there's also. There's that community aspect of when you do it in an open way, you can eyes are on you. People are going to be watching you. And so there's less risk of scams and of that sort when it's all in the open because there's that self-regulation within the community. And I think that's important.
Yeah, no, 100%. And I mean, we used to keep everything in the Discord back like a year ago. You know what I'm saying? then. And now we started to like filter it out with people's posts about like getting this out into Twitter. You know, we kind of shifted the way that we operate a little bit, but I think that's a great point as far as keeping that, like, I don't know, for me, you know, if you're not paying attention, that's what we've always known. Like, if you're not paying attention, you could be left behind. Folks that are participating heavily in Grailed and still up there in the chat, I think that's a great incentive for them and an opportunity at the end of the day, right? For someone that likes me, like, participating out on Twitter, it's a little different. So, like, some stuff's going on with Wizards that I haven't quite caught. I know that there's talk of a second flame, possible second flame with lore going around. And so, like, I'm not going to miss out on that as Runeverse is coming along. But you've got to be active to get those goodies, right? And I think that's well said, Atari, as far as opportunity for participation.
Yeah. Also, Runeverse, if anybody's watching from that team, if you hear this message, we'd love to have you on the damn show. We're looking at you. We want to talk about what you guys got going on Halloween. So just going to put it out there and let the universe work its magic. We also, yeah, maybe please, it's if you have some thoughts. And also, when we are ready, I see that Mimi Chan has entered the chat.
So my only thought is that I really felt uncomfortable sharing that I won the raffle. And afterwards, I thought about it, and I was like, I shouldn't be feeling like this. But
right.
That's it. That's the only thing I want to share. And we can go to Mimi.
Okay. So with maybe you set this up, so I want you to introduce this. Please take it away.
Okay. So months ago, I think it was like maybe 8 months ago or something, we got like an art contest going on the Grail channel. It was one of those low Thursdays that we were like, what's gonna happen this Thursday? And we got the art contest. And some people were like, oh, okay, just an art contest this week. But no, I was super pumped because it ended up being an incredible week because we got so many art pieces created by community members, like so many people that participated. And there were like, there were day packs from Wen Moon. Like she was going to give this day packs to a certain amount of people that won the art contest. And the person that got, I think, the number one spot, even if we were not like numbered, but I remember that Wagmi-san's tweet about the contest had her creation number one. And we're talking about Mimi Chan, and she created the amazing nails with all 10 KTF team. She's today with us, with her boyfriend as well, that I met before in the past. I met him in London. Let me get them in. Hello, guys.
Hi.
Hello.
So we're Mimi Chan.
How's it going?
How are you guys? So I'm Mimi Chan, and my boyfriend Alex is helping me with the English if I need it.
Yeah. But Bendongu is my Discord name, Bendongu. I suppose. Yeah, right. Yeah. How are you guys
Perfect.
Doing? Really good show today, by the way.
Thank you. Here, I'm just getting this set up so we can get you guys front and center. There we go. So, thank you. First of all, I'm gonna share Mimi Chan your Twitter feed so we can show some of the creations that you've made. Because there are swimmers that maybe haven't seen it or weren't at the IRL event in Brooklyn where you had your own nail salon. So let's start with that just so we can set the context.
Thank
here.
You.
Yeah, that was incredible.
Thank you. Yeah, I saw the picture with you.
Yeah, we took pictures exactly in front of the salon. It was like so well done.
Yeah.
Great thing is that all the people in the community immediately recognized that. They were like, oh my god, this
really?
Is yeah, because those nails are super famous. Like after you won the contest, everyone in the community knew about that. So yeah.
Wow, I wish I was there.
Hopefully we'll get you next time. But this is the NFT NYC setup, where when mm-hmm. you walk in, honestly, it was front and center. As soon as you walked into New Tokyo, this was the first thing that we saw. Oh. It was your nail salon. We had your the creations that you had here. And then this is where the community members' names were. And it says maybe, maybe not here. It's at Dijon University somewhere down here. It said Tales. And so let's start with this. Mimi, when you heard that this was so front and center, how did you feel about that? Like, what was going through your head?
It was amazing because I didn't know, you know, like they're going to make my salon in New Tokyo at the event at New York City. So like I was watching the Discord and then I found a picture of my salon in New Tokyo. People were taking picture videos. I was like, wow, this is amazing. And I shared with Alex and
big surprise.
Yeah. And like, I just wanted to be there. Yeah. I wanted to fly to.
Yeah, I really hope next time we're going to be able to come, because like we were having so much fun and seeing community creations to be like exposed like this, but like in front of everyone. That was just incredible. Look, these are amazing. But you got like Thank you. Bit of everything. I love it. Like, wow, also. Apes, it's amazing. I love it.
Yeah, put everything together, all the community, you know.
How do you go about that process, if you don't mind me asking, Mimi? Like, because I'm like, I don't, you got me thinking about whether I need some nails, right? My wife definitely needs some nails, right? Like, now I'm thinking like I might need a pair too, right? Like, they are so phenomenal. And don't mind, like, How do you, the first concept, the first time I saw the nails, freaking mind blown. Mm-hmm. Like, oh my gosh, this is so creative to take a medium that they work with, that she works with traditionally, and then bridge 10 KTF into it. I mean, how do you, where'd the idea come from, if you don't mind me asking?
So the first one, the art competition one, like at the time, I didn't really know about 10KTF NFT stuff. Like Alex was talking about 10KTF NFT every day to me, and it was annoying to me, to be honest.
Guilty.
Like, you know, every day. And I was like, okay, again. But one day I came back from work, and then he was like, Mimi, this is the art competition. You should try on it. And I was like, it's already like.
It was like 11. Yeah. It was like 11 p.m.
Yeah,
night.
It was nighttime. I was like, I'm so tired, but should I do it? I shouldn't do it. But I was like, I like creating new stuff. Like, so I love my art and stuff. So I was like, if it's art competition, maybe I should do it.
Yeah.
Because I love to be, you know, competition, and I love to show my art, share my art to people. So I did it. I went back to my studio and...
What time were we there until?
I don't know, maybe like 3 a.m. or something.
Yeah, 3 a.m. It was ridiculous.
So it was difficult. And I knew some designs from 10KTF. So I was I researched more about it. And then I just put them together, like which color would be good, like what I should put. And then I made a first one. And after this one, you guys are sharing this long nails. I had more time, so I was like, I want to put all of them together, so you know, so people can be
go to the
like a community. It's not just so like Wagumi-san with like all the different communities.
Right, so initially it was these ones up here that you had created were submitted to the art contest, is that right?
The second one, the
these ones.
Yeah, the competition. Got it. Okay.
Yeah. Well, these ones were the first entry. Yeah.
Was the
very cool.
The Wagumi-san was the middle one.
You said you rushed these. You just threw these together late one night, huh?
Oh my gosh. Yeah, it took some fine tuning. And I kind of had to introduce her to some of the characters. But she took to it really, really quickly. And she's so incredibly talented. Really, yeah. She's so incredibly talented. Thank you. So it was pretty amazing just to watch and observe, because I don't know anything about nails really. So I just showed her a picture, kind of gave her some to do. I think we both had particular fun with the toads.
Toads, yeah.
The toads were really, really fun.
Where are the toads? We're on top, I think.
Yeah.
These ones here and these ones. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my god. So cool.
That's my favorite.
Yeah. Same.
I like them too. Like the details. You know that somebody. Mimi, I know how involved you are with 10KTF, but when you see these nails and you see the lore, you know that somebody has to really know 10KTF to know to include, mm-hmm. like, you know, the toads and Battletown and like the staking with the scissors. And so whether anybody else, I was like, somebody really knows 10KTF here, because you can see the love for it. And so just, I think what Damon was saying was that you did it late one night, but these are so incredibly well done, and they again they had their own shop in 10KTF's event.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, Alex, you know, shared with me lots of things, and after that, whenever they release new episode, like a new tweet, I was like just taking screenshots and then keeping the all the different arts. I want to make this on nails, you know, like what they make in the anime style is really amazing.
I think one of the like most impressive ones and concepts we kind of bounced off each other was the like the main set was the Wagmi with the crypto punk in the camera. I don't know if you managed to see I don't know if you can get a close up on that one.
I can.
But that one was, was really cool. I told her about, like, I gave her the idea, but I didn't think like the implementation would come out as good as it is. Yeah. But again, she's just so phenomenally talented. I think it just came out so well. She absolutely killed it. Have you guys got any favorites from the sets?
My favorite is the Battletown one, like the detail that went into that. Like, even it's kind of like that punk, like with the little circles. You like that? I was amazed, like with the cool cat that's sitting up top. The details in the character, the fact that it's like a small nail and you can read through that finite detail. Just the level of artistic quality on that is. I mean, beyond amazing. I'm waiting for the real M nails bar. I don't know if that's a thing or whether you're thinking about maybe having some Wagmi sets in the future, but like my wife is seriously interested, and I'm not even kidding. I'll probably rock a set to hold it down with her. If that's something you're interested in doing,
I would love to do that.
I'm hoping that might be something you're interested in doing in the future, but no pressure either, of course. I know it's a lot of work, and you have your own profession as well. So
maybe which is your favorite? Really...
Oh, good question.
Okay. That's a good question.
No, not here. It's not here. In the previous image. I love them all, so I'm not gonna go because of a specific, more because emotions. It's like the go on top and in the center, second row, the central one, because that's the first, like that's the first image that I have in my head of 10KTF. No, not one moon, second.
Oh, yeah, the Wagami-san.
The original Wagami-san. Like the first image of 10KTF that comes to my mind is that Wagami-san in its old shop. And I don't know, that's my favorite. I love it.
That was the first one I made.
Yep.
Oh,
cool.
Yeah, because I thought that was the first image of the 10KTF2.
It is.
You know? Yeah, the first shop and the Wagami-san on the top.
Mm.
That was the, I wanted to make the one the first time.
The OG of OGs.
the first day that we got in contact with 10KTF was that. Mm, and you, Atari, you don't have a favorite.
No, I have a favorite. I'm honestly, I'm going through. I have one in mind, but I want to make sure that it's favorite before I say it out loud. I thought that stylistically, I think just the fact that you captured the essence of the comics, and this is from the Rise with Wagmi. A lot of these are from that. Yeah. And so I thought that whole minute video was gorgeous with the music and the animation. And so when I see this, that's such a strong image that I remember. And then the Rise with Wagmi, with him with the swords. And then even I remember this from when the gangs were fighting. And so you got like the comic style. So I love that you were able to pull from the artistic elements and then put that on Nail. So it's like, for me, these three right here really stand out as like, because I thought those are some of Tenkitiev's best art pieces, and you were able to take that energy and put them on here, and I thought that was amazing. So for me, it's these.
Beautiful.
Thank you. How about you?
It's a really nice compliment.
It's crazy. They're so perfect and beautiful. The cat also, like, so perfectly drawn.
It's
so difficult to think that a hand, like in something so small, also and handmade. It's like, it's crazy. That's the craziness for me, is that you did it by hand on these small nails. It's like, I'm shocked, and you're so talented. I love all of this.
Thank you.
They should be collectibles.
Thanks. Yeah. Really.
Ready.
So Mimi and Alex, I want to ask you, which one are your favorites?
Oh, that's a good question.
Which one yours?
Down to like the larger sets. Well, I really like the villain here. The villain here is awesome.
One, right?
Yeah, so I really like the bored ape kind of holding hands with the pudgy. I just think that is like so cute. I just can imagine the pudgy needing a hand to be held, you know.
And the cool cat is holding the woman's hand.
And the cool cat's holding the world woman's hand as well. I just think that was nothing to do with me. Maybe we did the research of the characters, and we kind of came up with some that should be on the nails, but the whole concept of, like, you know, the comical aspects which she managed to put into the detail of the nails was all her, and her imagination. And I just love, like, that's just when I see that nail, I just think, oh wow, that's Mimi's personality, and also 10KTF, which is awesome. So yeah, it just kind of expands the imagination of what you can really do with your NFTs, and it enhances the personalization of them, which is quite cool as well.
Thank you.
And Mimi, how about you? Any favorites? Sorry, Diamond.
It's so difficult to say. But I like this, yeah.
I'll zoom out for you.
Yes. Thank you. It's hard. But also the bottle, you know. How do you say this bottle?
Oh, yeah.
That, you know, like a blue bottle.
Yeah, the coda bottle, I guess you'd call it.
Oh, yes.
I like those too. Yeah. I just hit it to, like...
Yeah.
People can see, but it's still, like, hiding. Like.
Yeah.
So,
and you can see the little toads hiding up here as well, looking
exactly.
at it.
Exactly.
Like
yeah.
Just sneaky, sneaky thing, like.
That toad took ages to do. I think we had a few redos of that one.
Yeah.
It was so hard just to get the.
I just
looking...
wanted to make sure they were hiding and then make a sneaky face.
Yeah. The sneaky face is really hard.
Yeah, looking for the bot.
Yeah, she's such a perfectionist, so. Yeah, but I think all in all, amazing, amazing work.
Yeah. I just like, and it's not just like art, it's also including the story that what they're making. So it's nice to put all together. Like people can see, oh yeah, this was from that story, this was that from that story, and they can connect together.
Before I give it off to you, I was just gonna say you're in one of these.
Yeah, yeah, that's literally what I was getting ready to say. That's my new favorite. Like that we were getting ready to say the same thing, right? Like I was like, oh yeah. Man, I was like the Battle.Town when I first saw that, like the first original Battle.Town, so amazing. But now that I see a diamond hand in there, that diamond handed chair in the shop, that's for sure my favorite male now. Yes. Thank you, Mimi.
I did it.
Thank you so much.
When I saw the diamond hand in a new shop, and I was like, oh, I should do this.
Yeah. You're
much.
An OG Diamond Hands. Come on.
Yeah.
Oh, every time. OG. If I was being honest, when I walked in New Tokyo, because I've never left the West Coast in my life. So like going to New York for me from California was a big deal. Like, I walk into the portal and knows, hears my voice and turns around. Is that Diamond Hands? And I'm like, yeah. Hey, what's up? And he's like, oh, it's Nose. And I'm like, oh, Nose, hey, buddy. And then I take a next step around the corner, and it's M's Nail Bar right there. And I'm like, oh, my gosh. And so, like, at that point, I had seen myself in the story, right, with the diamond-handed chair in the shop, right, and been thinking about, what's this all look like for us in the future? And then to see M's Nail there in real life, it was like, okay, this is part of – they're trying to teach us how to fish, whatever that is, right? Like, we can now, like, this is what the future of the digital, like, New Tokyo looks like. M's going to, Mimi Chan to have her nail bar, and then she'll be able to sell 10 KTF nails off to the side of it for folks. Like, that's something she's interested in doing, right? Because we all get our own autonomy in a decentralized Web3. But, like, if that's something she's interested in doing, she's going to have all these true fans just waiting to get some nails, like, my wife, like, we're dead serious as soon as we can get a pair. I don't know whether we got to do that in the DMs or what, Mimi, but like, if we can, as soon as we can, we're seriously interested in that, you know, with Thank what you, you do with your art and your creativity. It's seriously beautiful. And I think that's part of the bigger ethos of hopefully how we can all become to see ourselves in Web3. It's a very, unconventional, it's not well described or well defined right now, but I think as we continue to move forth into what the metaverse can be, talking about these immersive experiences, what could be more immersive than like having your own nail bar, right? The inclusion in the opportunity to the future. With the damn show, I've never done any sales route stuff, right? And like now we have a Shopify, like we got this Captain's Brew like coffee. And I've never sold anything in my entire life. Like I'm terrible at sales. I'm the worst. But it's taught me a few things along the road. And I think for the larger 10KTF grailed ethos, seeing your M's Nail Bar in real life for me really brought it home that like this is the vision. This is the future. You know, you can do something that you love instead of having to work somewhere where you might not always feel as appreciated or whatever it is, right? But like do what you love and you'll never have to work another day in your life. And I think that there's an opportunity in Web3 there for us. So for me, it was like, yeah, these are the connective tissues. These are the bigger pieces, you know? And thank you so much, Mimi. And Alex, shout out to you, man. Putting together the pieces in the background. Because my wife gets tired. Same thing, Mimi. My wife gets tired sometimes. I'm like, let me tell you what happened to Alex. You know, like, are you
ready? Yeah.
So thank you all so much. I really can't say it enough. Amazing stuff and really excited.
Thank you.
Look to see what happens in the future.
Yeah. Keep Maybe do you have a
Yeah. Thank you.
Maybe please go ahead.
I just wanted to say that I was so happy that they finally made it because I think the first time I messaged her, it was like maybe half of July, end of July. Mm. It was like we were just the first episodes of the damn show. And she was, you know, completely different time zone. And it was like, it was too hard for her. Mm. And like, you know, this thing, like, I'm so happy that we finally made it, because it's been a while that I really wanted to get her on the show so that she could show everyone what she does and make everyone see who was the winner of that, and who was the person that created those nails at the in real life event. So yeah, that's what I wanted to say. Really, really happy to have you here today, finally.
Thank you so much. We are so happy to see you guys too, like, finally.
I mean, you know what I think about? I think about the next 10KTF IRL event. The last one had this nail salon, but I think this one needs to have the Mimi Chan there and, like, yes, custom nails for everybody. Yes. I feel like I would love that.
I'm going to walk there. I'm going to do the nails there.
Yes.
Amazing.
Hey, yeah, people, for sure. We should be there.
The peak of Charleston. You know, Beeple's got that the factory, the museum he's building in Charleston right now, and he's definitely indicated on crazy Crypto Carl's Twitter space that we did that, like, we're for sure gonna have a 10KTF event there. So, like, yeah, Mimi, pretty sure that they could find a spot for you to get a table. Maybe just one time, we'd all be hyped to watch you do some nails live. I don't know how you'd feel about it, but, like,
oh,
that'd be awesome.
Dude, that'd be crazy.
Be lit, absolutely crazy.
Yeah. I just need a little table there.
Amazing. Mimi Chan, Alex, thank you guys so much.
Not a little table.
Thank you so much, guys. Thank you. Really, thank you. Take care.
Take care, everybody.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
That was so wholesome. Maybe thank you for setting that up. That was awesome. So nice to finally see the like the creators behind some of, like, the really cool things that we've seen, but we haven't had a chance to put a face and name to a voice to. And so I know it's late for them. They're out across the pond, and so it's getting late for them as well. But super awesome that they could jump in and share some of the stories. And I think that we have to have them at the next IRL event doing like an exhibit. I feel like that'd be such a nice touch.
Super cool.
You do the damn live and swing by Mimi with her nail bar, like, just throw that in as part of the damn live that we're doing, like, in the bridge. Yeah, you know, cross content is the future of 10KTF, y'all. I'm telling you, cross content.
100%. There's so many possibilities. Like, we can, the world is our oyster. Everybody that's listening and watching, the opportunity, there's more opportunity out there than you can even imagine, and it's ours for the taking. And so, I think with that, maybe. Is it time? Is it time? As
time
we look forward.
Now, the time is wow.
The time is now to also look back on a new segment at the Damn Show called Throwback Thursday.
All right, yes. Okay, so for the first episode of the Throwback Thursday, so we were thinking about, okay, we do this live stream on Thursday, but what's one of the most famous Thursday things ever in the planet? It's Throwback Thursday. So let's see what happened in the past, right? So yeah, for today, we prepared something that actually happened literally like 1 year ago. It was like 1 year and 6 days ago, something like that. So I can start sharing. No, wait one sec. Okay, here I am.
I think I know what it is. Let's go.
I can start sharing. It was exactly on October 7, 2021. So October 7, 2021 was a date that we were awaiting a lot, because with all of the pieces that we put together, it was like, you said 10, not 7. And then Wagmi-san mm-hmm. answered 7, not 10 on the 10. So there was a 7, 10, 7, 10. So what we were thinking, okay, guys, 10, 7, right? October 7. Something is absolutely going to happen on October 7. And that's what happened exactly at 10 p.m. Pacific time. So it was pretty late for in the East Coast. But by like at the time, I was living in the Pacific Coast. So for me, it was not so bad. So I put together a list of messages from that night. And you can see it starts with Dani T. You know her. She's a part of the team at World of Women now. I don't think that she was back then yet. But anyway, she wrote, "So are we going to get airdropped tonight?" They were like, we were waiting for it. Here it says 10:08 because now I'm East Coast, so it was after midnight for the East Coast, but for the Pacific Coast it was still before midnight.
We were partying hard on the West Coast. We were partying hard
until at one point, like, this was crazy. That was like, was it like the third Thursday that we were together? I don't know. Like, the party was crazy. Shut up, Vitoshi. Did
lit.
I miss something? Tails, Atara, we were all there. Look, 30 countdown. Minutes. Countdowns, yeah, like 30 minutes before 10 p.m. Pacific, Black Amethyst. He found out that something happened.
In New York.
Yeah, we met him in New York. So something was happening in the contract. So you know what we were doing at the beginning was always checking the contract, what's happening with the contract.
Yeah. Hey, we were the crazy beans back then. I mean, that was so much fun too. I don't know. I just remember how hard we used to go with the gifts. Selector was in the chat back then, y'all. Like running
yes.
the
yeah, Selector. Like, boom.
Shout out Ryan Schreiber. Just, I was listening to What's Good last night, just sitting by the beach, y'all. It's such a vibe.
What's good? What's good, baby? Yeah. Mm-hmm. This is what a day, people, what a night. 1 year ago.
People were very happy with the. With the music, so we were, you know, praising Selector a lot. We were like, Selector is amazing. So look, Atari is helping us navigating EtherScan. So two new contracts minted by Wagmi.
I remember, I was like, I don't know what the fuck that means, but it sounds like something good, you know? And then thank goodness. EtherScan, I think we had like the week before, or it was like the week after this, that we had EtherScan University. Because I was like, oh, well, thank goodness, because I don't know still what's going on. I can track that things get sent from one wallet to a next if I go to etherscan.io. Two thumbs up.
Yeah.
So Lola also, everybody was helping. Like, we were there. We knew that something was going to happen. Something was happening. So
Jude.
We were partying hard.
Hey, Jude.
More addresses, more sharing.
What's that, Kim?
Look at here.
On it.
New NFTs made.
Wisdom for sure. Skip class the next day.
Yeah. Yes, I'm going to answer now. I hope he skipped. So, yeah.
Hey, by the end of the semester, we were all worried whether Wisdom was going to pass or not. Y'all remember that? Like, Wisdom missed a bunch of days, y'all. Wisdom held it down. Legend.
Here we were so far away from our in real life party, and we were already talking about it. So keep the playlist for the in real life party. Yes. It was crazy. And then the first in real life party happened in March. So this was October. So pretty far.
Yeah. Very long time.
Then we got Nikki also. Nikki is super sweet. We miss you so much, Nikki. This song is dedicated
to Nikki. We miss you.
Here. Super sweet. And yeah, she was sweet. She was very sweet, but also very harsh. Like in the right moment.
Very firm.
Like,
firm.
Very firm. Like she could be both. But when she needed to be firm, she was. And right. Yeah, we loved her.
We love that energy because you need a mom. She was the mom of the Discord, and she knew when to like be fair, knew when to be firm.
100%.
Come back.
When we broke the Toads Discord on our first field trip, y'all, she called me into a private room and whooped my ass. Right, like figuratively. Right, like she's like, Diamonds, we can't. You know, we love you, but we can't be breaking our fucking parent Discord servers. All right, and I'm like. Word, thank you for that. You know, just being like firm in the right direction, but also like with the right nurturing. I don't know. I fucking love Nikki. I can't wait for her to get back.
And meeting her in person was amazing. I that was one of the first shopkeepers that I was like, I have to meet Nikki. Where is she? And we had a nice conversation, and she talked about, you know, building the community and just her perspective on how she saw it, because she was there from day zero, you know, building this community that they then got to see in March come to real life. We had people fly, and I flew in specifically for just that event. So incredible.
Yeah. Also, let's remind everyone, if you have any anecdote or anything you want to say about that day you were there, you want to share something, tweet about this. Just use the hashtag TBTOnDam, and we are gonna be showing all your tweets. Just for OGs that wanna, you know, just hang out, just wanna share this moment with us. Obviously, not expecting everyone to do it, but if you just wanna share this something with us, we're here listening. And let me go to the next.
Can I tell you something hilarious about this? So this is my first chat in Grailed. Right. So like that's arrives in Grailed, y'all. I had no idea there was a fucking Grailed chat, kind of like a Tare. And like when I showed up on Etherscan, I just showed up like, I'm doxed, y'all. Everyone's doxing. Right. Like I didn't know there was an additional level of the chat. So like we're just trying to keep general hype. What the fuck is going on, y'all? Like I had already been in the chat for like fucking two weeks prior to this, and then had to like, I finally found Grailed at that time. And so, yeah, you live, you learn, and you get better. What's up, y'all?
Yeah, this was so cool. It was like, what's going on in here? So, yeah, more partying, Bam Bam, Idiaki, all going crazy with us. It feels like they were a bit more active with us in the past. Guys, come back, because I love to, you know, be more, I don't know, maybe they just have three times the amount of work that they had back then. I don't know, just saying, but it felt like they were more active in the chat with us. They were like partying with us and everything. I remember dancing with Jury in Grailed. So yeah, that was cool. So we started talking about the fact that we're going to be making some stuff, that there's going to be, you know, different items that they're going to be airdropped to make stuff. Sorry. Okay. No, wait. Okay, at 10 p.m. PT, the music stops. And shopkeeper puts this. Shopkeeper Nikki, she puts this. And we're like, okay, this is quiet. What's going on? So everyone, it's happening. Level 17, oh my God. Okay, long ago. Music cut, music stop. Oh my God, what happened? A lot of stuff. Let's see what else we got. What was this? This Atari saying the music cut. And then they start minting more stuff. So they start minting, and this is the first transaction. This is a very fun moment. I think you should go with it. There were three mints, right? Three different attempts.
Yeah.
So this is the first one.
Yeah. Okay, so we saw that there were transactions that were sent, and the first one failed because they didn't put enough gas or whatever reason. Or it says right there, warning, out of gas. So they reverted it. So contract never executed. And so we're all just like, come on, like we had a countdown, and now the transactions are failing. And then what's the next message? So yeah, okay. So this was such a funny moment because I took stock and I was like, can you believe we're literally watching an internet we knew minute by minute scrutinizing their every move, because everybody was waiting for this contract to go live. Wisdom says it right there. Wow, 1.8 ETH fail. And so they had put 1.4 ETH to deploy this contract, and it still failed.
Yeah, that was crazy. So
we're all like laughing at that idea. And then I think there's some more attempts, and there were some more fails.
Yeah, this was attempt two. And tails up the gas.
To melon fan.
No. We want our stuff.
and then this ties into...
Bro.
Like, bro. It failed again. And then this all tied into Shopkeeper O2 was at the IRL party. And he pulled me aside at one point and was like, yo, Atari, I got some beef with you. And I'm like, what's up, Shopkeeper O2? And he's like, do you remember when you said that we're watching the intern fail at uploading these contracts? And I start dying. And I'm like, of course, that was hilarious. And he's like, that was me. I was trying to upload them or like get them to go live on Ethereum. And everybody on the team started laughing and started calling me Weenu intern for like weeks onward because of your message. And so he's like, I have beef with you, my man. It was such an amazing moment.
Bam, patience. First rule, me son. When guest goes high, we go higher. Okay. We can do this. Wisdom always the positive, always there. It was so cool.
Yeah.
Tails, I was like, I could every message Tails was putting out, I was just laughing so hard.
Like,
stop throwing away the heat, what the hell? That was so funny.
ETH was pricey back then too, y'all. ETH was not a fucking joke back then, you know?
It was 3K.
Yeah, hey, I just saw Classic Mitch up, and it just reminded me of when he had the giveaway, like the first 10K TF giveaway. It was Classic Mitch up, y'all. Is about back this time too. Shout out Classic Mitch. He did a little giveaway on Twitter. Bugsy ended up Bugsy Mugs, which is one of the fucking hilarious, like, Mugsy Bogues. If y'all don't know 80s basketball, that's freaking hilarious, all right? Bugsy Mugs ended up winning it, and then they both donated. I think they both ended up donating like an amount of money back to shelters as well, like on top of the gifting that went on there. And so like just going back through the ethos and like the good people we got in 10K TF, y'all, you know, it might take time right for us all to wag me or whatever, but like we got good folk around here. And that's what I love most about this community. What up, Nose? Welcome back, fam.
And so finally...
This is the one.
We finally went live. This is the tools and materials airdrop. Finally got pushed through. And then maybe what happened next?
And then next we got some messages from, we have messages from Natech that Natech gets everything. I write Natech a ton, and after my message, he puts his answers. I know, first we got Robo with a thank you message. Congrats to everyone. That was like a very sweet message, because obviously we were all very happy, all celebrating each other. People that got like one item, the people that got 100 items, like we were all happy and having fun together. then we got a message from Natec. I'm so happy. Thank you so much, Wagmi-san and team. I was so nervous I'd only get one material, our OG whale. One material, right?
Yeah. So, yeah.
This was me. What I got? What did you get, Atare, asking me? What did you get? Cloth, rubber, and thread. Yeah, I didn't get any tools. I was like, okay, it was not my moment to be lucky. Next time, maybe. But yeah, I was happy anyway. I was doing some calculations in my head. And anyway, going back to the fact that I got all of these materials from mints that were like 0.05, it was incredible the amount of value that I got, even not getting any tools. So I was like, just to look at yours, just look at what you put in and what you're getting out. And what I was getting out was amazing, even if I didn't get three tapes like someone else. But it was still a win for me. And then I put Konop a message that was... I like how people sell before they even know what the fuck they are. Like the voice of the truth. I don't know how to say it another way.
Voice,
like,
of reason.
Voice of reason, because that's exactly what happening. People selling those tools when,
yeah,
it's like we have no idea what's going on with all of this, but you know, it's the market and it's always gonna happen. But yeah, it was a very, very fun night that we got to spend all together, and it was very late when it ended also, because it's like the airdrop started a little bit after 10 p.m. Pacific time. So it was pretty late on the East Coast. And we got this going for, I think, 1 or 2 hours, something like that. So,
yeah.
Yeah, long night, but we had a lot of fun.
And
let's close with Bam Bam.
Grailed will be rewarded. Ah, the original lore. Ah, what a time.
Let me answer now.
Yes.
If it wasn't the 7th, it was the 8th that I started the 10KTF daily recap and the bulletins. So it was right about this time too, in response to all the movement that we were having in the chat.
Mm-hmm.
This is when it all fired off. I was already like, y'all know we were all just degenning before then, but this is when it all, like the research end of it, for me at least, really kicked off.
Yeah. Ah, yeah. What a time, what a time. And we're going to, one year from now, we're going to look back on all the Kagami madness and be like, ah, what a time. Remember when? So... That was a new segment called Throwback Thursday. Let me play us out here, guys. Oh, hey, it's us again.
We're back.
We're back. So, Throwback Thursday, a lot of lessons in that. Maybe it's been 1 year. Let's go through some like high level reflections. Maybe.
Okay, so a high level of reflection is that, first of all, energy was very high and we were all very positive about anything that was happening. So mm-hmm. I really... Like looking back, I kind of miss it a bit. Like the way we were all celebrating the whole time, it was more about the fact that we were spending the evening together, and the fact that it was something new for many of us. Because like, let's say, like, 10KTF is the first project, at least for me, but I've never heard about other projects doing like real parties like we were doing in 10KTF, like starting to dance, get the music going, everybody listening to the radio, everybody dancing, you know. So it was like a magic moment per se. And then the fact that we got the airdrop, we all felt rewarded. And of course, many people got more, like vast majority of people got more than me. For example, I had a very small amount of items. That's why I didn't get so many materials, stuff like that. But I remember the night as an amazing night. I was like, I wasn't even comparing myself with others, to be honest. I was more like, like I said before, I thought, okay, I think my high tops were rare. Maybe I should have gotten 2 items. Maybe I should have gotten something different. Yeah. I don't know. But I didn't even open a ticket at the end. I was like, well, this is what I got. This is what was in store for me. And that's it. And I'm going to be happy for it. I wasn't even, you know, expecting it. Everything was so new. So I just have this memory of a very, very positive energy. I don't know what you guys remember from that night.
Diamond?
I just remember, yeah, I got that stuff dropped to me. So I didn't, like, I didn't really understand 10KT yet. Like, we were all figuring it out then, right? Like, that's still early in the chat. I just started, like, we have so much going on here. I think it would be decent to try to, like, keep a grounded information source for this is like what I started thinking at this point, right? Like, this is obviously moving and we didn't know what it was. No one had, we hadn't really clearly defined. Mm-hmm. I think it was like the 22nd of the 22nd of October or 20 something it was, when, like, that's the first time I wrote, like, Wagmi San is the greatest mystery in NFTs, a D&D style interactive textual game where you solve riddles and clues. I don't know if y'all remember me writing those OG theories, but, like, we hadn't constructed what 10KTF was quote unquote to be at that time. We were still figuring it all out. And so, like, for the material drop and the tool drop, all I got was materials. I got, like, roll of rubber. I got some stuff, you know, I got some good stuff, but I didn't have any rares, uncommons. All I had was just common, right? I was lucky to be in the project at that time. And so I wasn't, like, feeling any type of way. I was super hyped for Sesh, who pulled 3 tapes, right? Like, we were all partying for Sesh. No one was like, oh, Sesh, like, man, kick me back one of those tapes, homeboy. Like, you should give it back to the team or anything like that, right? It's like, fucking let's go, Sesh. Let's fuck it. That's a come up. Like, let's fucking go. Let's celebrate the moment.
Yeah.
And so, like, for me, I just remember at that time, I mean, I didn't have any extra ETH. ETH was, like, at 4,000, right? Like, I've never, like, so for me, to be able to mint, I just remember Swilson reaching out and Swilson being like, hey, Diamonds. What's up, man? Like, I got some tools. We've been talking about the way tools were going to get shared for a little bit before that. And, you know, creating an ethos of the way that this could work, Wagmi could work. And let's be very clear. The team had no fucking idea that we were going to completely deflate the market that they were building, right? Like, we chose to do that as a community. That's something that's fucking awesome, y'all. Like, in the history of NFTs, and when they all look back and say, oh, yeah, like, we know creatures made people join together. That's how 2Degrees and Atari linked up to 10KTF, right? Yep. But, like, when has a community ever decided to deflate a fucking market to try to create an ethos of real, like, Wagmi, of a feeling that everyone's going to make it, that no one's in a better place than anyone else? Like, that's where Wagmi started, y'all. And, like, I just, as we continue to get deeper into market value and market aspects, I hope that we can hold true the values of the days when it was just for fun, you know, and it is for fun. We're all true fans to the fullest. But I just remember if Swilson hadn't reached out, like, Swilson hit me in the DMs and was like, Diamonds, I'm going to send you these tools. And then she sent me enough ETH to be able to mint my shit together, or else I wouldn't have been able to afford the mints as they were. Right. She's like, I want you and your wife to sit together and do some minting. And, like, there's a whole, like, UI, like the interface on 10ktf.com. You got to be with your wife when you do this. OK. And here's some ETH and here's all my fucking tools. Here's $16,000 in tools. and a little bit of ETH on top, okay? And I want you and your wife to have a great fucking time tonight. And it was like, who the fuck is this lady? Like, what the fuck is going on around here? I was just so fucking mind blown. Like, the ethos of, like, honestly, good people out here looking out for people who are just trying to find an opportunity, right? I don't know. Shout out to Wilson. I mean, she knows how much I love her. I just, for me, that was really, that's the juice. Those are the good times, you know?
Yeah. I think I share very similar elements to all of that, because there was a I got lucky. I got a thimble and I got scissors, and then I got a couple other like materials as well. So like for me, I'm like, and I had like, I think maybe 5 or 6 items, maybe 8, I don't remember exactly, but something like that is what I started off with. And yeah, I was like, for me, I was also on the end of like, if we share, then the value of these tools are going to get deflated. And for me, it's like, yeah, my market cap of tools, the value dropped by like $8,000 to $12,000 overnight. But I was okay with that. I don't think I ever raised any complaints, because I'm like, in the long term of all of this, what's better? And I remember saying this, is it better that only certain people get the craft, or is it better that we take the L, if you want to call it that, in the short term, and believe that in the long term, it's way better to get way more new people in the project so that they could experience this and enjoy this and we grow all of this. And down the line, it's like, we'll trust. And there's that trust element. Crypto is trustless, but there's a lot of trust in all of this still, because to be human is to trust. That's how you know. That's how you know we're making it.
I got busted again, y'all. I got fucking busted again. This is bullshit. This is fucking bullshit.
Yeah, I was in the zone, and that just threw it off.
Where's Paper D when we need him? Tinder is back, baby. What's up?
Tinder hands. back to what I was saying. It was the collective ethos of that. This is better for is to welcome new people in and let them craft and let people have stuff and not just sit on blanks. So for me, it was the ethos, and I still share that ethos. Somebody mentioned it earlier. They said that he agrees about newcomers being equally rewarded, and that's the balance that we have to keep in all of this. Is there's going to be new people being rewarded, there's going to be that provenance being rewarded, and there's always going to be a dance. And if you know, 20 badgers, 19 badgers were rewarded for this more than newcomers, then there would be people that are, you know, newcomers that would say, hey, that's kind of bullshit. Like I joined in August, but why do I get lower chances and all of this? And that would have been a whole thing. And so it's like, at the end of the day, you can't make everybody happy. And that was very true in the tools airdrop of a year ago. And you live with that. I want to wait till maybe gets back, because this is one of the things how maybe carried herself throughout.
My bad, your voice rugged out on a sitare. You said when Mimi carried us through, and then it rugged. Could you say that one more time?
Oh, am I back now? Am I back?
Yeah,
I can hear you.
I was gonna say maybe, and I haven't shared this with you, but it's something that I reflect on when I think about the tools airdrop. Is that how you navigated that really stood out to me, in terms of the kind of person that you are, because for you, you didn't get any tools, and there was going to be difficulties crafting if it had to come down to, you know, buying tools if there wasn't going to be the sharing component. And so I reflect back, and I'm not just saying this, I remember seeing it at the time as well, where despite you being there quite a lot and, you know, bringing really good energy, good vibes, I didn't get a lick of complaints, or I hear complaining from you of being like, why didn't I. And I thought that was very admirable. That stood out to me, and it's like it reflects on the fact that I think we build up who we all are in our minds based on, you know, the activity that we see on Discord and Twitter and eventual Twitter spaces. And it's like, that's one of like a defining pillar of me being like, maybe is one of the good ones, like one of the great ones to like really keep in touch with, because it would have been so easy to honestly go down that rabbit hole of like, I'm here all the time and I didn't get rewarded and this and that and that and that. And I never sensed that from you. And I thought that was very admirable just in how you carried yourself throughout that whole saga.
Thank you. Oh, yeah. It was like, I don't know. I always think like, why I deserve it more than someone else? Like, I don't know all the data. I don't know all the anything that is happening inside, behind the curtains from the team. Why are they doing it? Like, every time before just complaining, I ask myself, why are they doing it? Mm. And usually I can find a reason. I've been talking about it with someone recently, and I was like, maybe I can find a reason because I run a business too. So
right.
I understand what it means to be on the other side, like to be the one that takes the decisions and then see the consequences. And I try to understand, okay, so why are they doing this way? I always put as first is that like the first thing that I think is not obviously not because they want to destroy their own project. They're doing all of this to make the project grow, to make the project more successful, which is going to be a good thing for all of us at the end of the day, because they can gift us everything. They can give us one airdrop per week, but then it's not sustainable anymore and the project goes to zero. And then we're going to be like, okay, this is over. Nice, right? All this for what? You know, I prefer to get like to see them taking these decisions. And then on the back of my head, I think about it and I think like, okay, there is a reason business-wise why they did it. And it's something that makes sense for me. So I just trust that they're going to do the best for the company, the best for the project. And at the end of the day, like at the end of the whole story, not the day, at the end of the whole story, that's going to be good for me because I'm a holder. I believe in the project. So yeah, it was, I don't feel like complaining so much most of the time. So yeah, for this for all reasons.
I remember when these all dropped, like we did have members in the chat, like snipe sharking. I called it snipe sharking over each other. I was like, y'all better cut the snipe sharking shit out, because it was people looking at the market at the larger ethos. And I remember saying like, if y'all think that I'm going to use someone else's tools and y'all are going to gift me tools without gifting them to everyone else too, because at that point I was doing recaps and a couple people hit me in the DMs and be like, Diamonds, don't worry. Right. We got you, man. We got you, fam. Like whatever ends up happening. And I'm like, so like, that's awesome that the whales are going to look out for me, but how would the people with one bag, one item feel about this? You know? And so I remember calling out snipe sharks in the chat. Like back in those days, I was like talking through emotion. Right. And so it's like, we can't be fucking snipe sharking each other like that. That's not how we're all going to make it, y'all. Because there was this like initial market aspect of it. Right. And so like, see the community, like, once again, think about the larger moment and like, fuck, you know what? This is the kind of market aspect. And then like you're saying, we're going to go farther together. We'll go faster alone, right? You're going to get that bag alone, but we're going to go farther together. And look at what's come since then, the way that this project operates in a different manner, in a different ethos, right? The way that our community gets down. It's kind of shifted with Kagami's, but I think that's a beautiful point to relate it back to. Like, right? Like, we can acknowledge it. Like, there's no point in not. Let's not run from this. This shit is weird right now compared to the historical precedents and the moments that we've had earlier. And that's okay, right? Because in time, we've noticed that everything's hyperized in 10KTF. This is a moment. And I promise y'all, it will pass, right? Yeah. And I know that I'm saying someone who has a Kagami. So, like, I'm kind of a shithead for that. But at the other end, like, I also know what this means in the long term. And I know how much this team cares about us. Just one of us, all of us, right? Especially the ones that have been along for the long term of the journey. So for whatever that is, you know, I just hold solid, y'all. There's a lot of good things still coming around the corner, but we got to believe in true friends and WAGMI in the ethos for the long term, not for the moment.
Yes, well said.
Yeah, very well said. And yeah, like I mean, that, I think that puts a cap on. We've all said our piece on like the past week, and then also reflecting it back to last year's airdrop with the tools. So I'm happy that we had that segment today, maybe with Throwback Thursday, because I think it's like it's the same thing. It's the same thing, and it's just two different ways of navigating it, or two different ways of, like, you know, sharing how it happened. And so, yeah, I mean, not much else for me to honestly really say. I think there's we have the Kagami movement later today, and I think for what it's worth, I said it earlier today, I think 3 to 4 weeks, all of this will be a nothing burger. It'll be like the people that wanted to get it are going to be able to get it at a reasonable price, because this is a very niche item. This isn't something that somebody else outside of 10KTF is going to want to get, because it's not for them. It's a collectible piece for a very small niche group of people. And so we're not really going to see crazy, at least in my opinion, crazy premiums. Maybe down the road, as you know, the supply dwindles, and maybe if there's more utility. But for all we know, and what we've heard, it's this is just a collectible art piece with some new technology that we've seen a couple times now at NFT LA and NFT NYC as well. And so, yeah, like I don't even know if I'm going to redeem mine just as soon as possible, because for me, I'm going to be on the run. Not on the run. I'm going to be on the move. And I mentioned it earlier, but getting physical items makes it difficult, because then you add to just, like, you know, the stuff you have to carry and protect and all that. And so for me, it makes sense to just kind of keep it as a memento, totally digital, and then down the road decide what I want to do with it. That's at least what I think I'd be doing. Diamond, how about you?
Same thing, man. You know, just checking out my financial situation. I love 10KTF to the tilt, you know, but like if there's a financial opportunity here that builds, like you're saying, it's a niche market, but there might be somebody out there where we watch the floor for this, knowing that it's the one asset that's not inflationary in 10KTF's ecosystem, other than the tools, right? Tools and materials. Like, as far as the larger collection, you know, I'm going to hold off on minting mine, and then keep an eye on the collection for a little while. It seems like patience in these things is probably the best.
Patience has always kind of just played out in the best way, whether it was for tools, whether it was for, I don't know, like in general, if you were patient for most things in 10KTF and didn't react to the emotions, you mm-hmm. were rewarded. And so the same principle here, I think it applies. Pantro saying, is there a time frame to redeem it? No, I don't. I think it's going to be an open redeem. So it'll just be available to buy unredeemed, and then you can redeem it if you want. I'm sure they're going to have like a kagami.10ktf.com portal where you're going to be able to enter the details so that you can physically get it. And then I think that portal is also going to be a way for you to upload your NFT, because it is a dynamic art piece, and it has said on the payment page that you're going to be able to upload your partner projects, the partner project PFPs onto it, and like stream it essentially. So yeah, I think it's going to be exactly like the crates.
So what I wanted to say is that today we have also the ape claim that should go in live.
Oh, yeah. But
it's not live yet. We were kind of expecting to have it live at 6 p.m. But we don't. So
I was just checking that, Netta. I just went and yeah, no ape coin there.
But there's no ape coin there. Where's
patience.
My ape coin?
Like Bam Bam says, patience, right? Rule number one with Wagmi. Patience.
Where the fuck is my ape coin? speaking of patience, I've been waiting 4 goddamn days.
So yeah, because I don't have, yeah, okay, so let's put it out to the world. I see even Directive Creator just wrote it in the chat. Yes, guys, so I won the Kagami. Diamond,
I won the Kagami.
Atare,
I won a Kagami. So
yeah, okay.
We got 3 for 3.
3 for 3 now, on the deck. super lucky. I can't
yeah,
believe
for
it.
Those and for the whispers and the secret chats and all that stuff, like, talk to somebody that works at Premint. Don't take it from us. Talk to somebody. Hit up Nucci. Hit up Brendan Mulligan. DM them and say, hey, for like a timed raffle, is it possible to rig it? Ask that. Just do your own research, check for yourself. I think even if it were true, I think whether the energy is joking or it's serious or it's a bit of both, I think at the end of the day, it's like, if the team decided if they could, and I don't think they can with Freeman, it's not possible, but if they did, quote unquote, rig it, did we make the decision? Did we DM them and say, hey, rig it for us? Or so it's like, if it were true, it's not even for us to defend or talk about, because it's like, we had no choice in it. It's not true, for the record, because technically you can't do that on Premint. But if you want to get your pitchforks, it's not for us. It's take it to the team. Like, that's not for like, yeah. Like, I just don't even see the logic in any of that. So there's that piece. Let's wrap it up. It's put a bow on it, send it off into the world, and we're done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And,
exactly.
Yeah, exactly what Smoking Gun says. So, yes, it's no man. You still have to pay for it. Yeah, okay. That's why I'm asking about the 10K TF, the 10K friends claim, because that's going to help me cover the cost.
If that doesn't go through, I'm not covering the cost, Netta. Like, you know what I'm saying? So I'm waiting out here. You know, I'm waiting.
We need that. Yeah, me too. I don't have 208 right now. I'm very happy with my claim, which is going to be pretty good. I got like 155. Then I got 5 ape from my Timbo from last month. So, you know, I had to add 40 ape. Not so bad, to be honest. So, yeah, I'm happy. I'm grateful. It has been pretty good. Also, I think on Battletown, for some reason, I was able to hit the right missions with the right amount of loadout. Even though on the captains, I gave only 30 points to Diamond Hands because it was already super high. So I don't know.
You still got your badge, fam. You still got your badge. Eh? Cheers.
So I don't know, but anyway, yeah, I got a good claim today, so I'm very happy about that. Thank you, team. Thank you, Wagmi-san, again.
And I want to give a special shout out to the SEC for investigating Yuga. The timing of it, just because ApeCoin ApeCoin dropped 50 cents. So 10%. Getting a little bit of cheaper ApeCoin, cheaper ApeCoin for all of us to buy up. So I haven't bought what I need yet. I need about, I don't know, like 50 to 70, something like that. I'll go ahead and convert it, but I'm not in a rush to do it. Also, my Thimble is still Thimble Gang. Shout out Thimble, let's go, baby. Still earning me that passive income so I can retire. I actually live off my Thimble earnings. So
yeah, me too. We're Thimble Gang. Oh wow, we're Thimble Gang here in like, I knew that you had it, but I never thought about it. The Dan,
yeah,
is
this is Thimble Gang three all three of us. Out of three Thimble Gang, 3 out of 3 Kagami Gang. Like, there must be something special happening in the damn universe. And speaking of the damn universe, I just got a notification somebody subscribed. Zayla just subscribed to our channel. Guys, if you haven't subscribed yet, speak of the devil, if you haven't subscribed yet, subscribe, like our channel. We do this every damn Monday, as Diamond, your shirt says, every damn Monday. And also boom, and also every damn Thursday. You got the cue.
I don't know if I hit the screen right, but I was just trying to get out there, you know?
We got 90% of it, so we got the message. What Bobby's up, Thimble Gang, what up, what up, what up? What up, Zay?
Hey, we got Bobby and Polaris hosting that new Oni Enclave space, right? Helping the bridge with San and Oni to 10K TF, right? Big time. Thank you, Bobby. Thank you, Polaris. Appreciate y'all.
Yeah. I don't know if I'm going to be able to join. I will try my best. I'm really trying to listen to some more spaces. Like on Monday, I was waiting for Crossfire. I was like, there, okay, I'm going to be there this Monday. It's going to be my first time that I listen to it. And then they postponed it. I was like, no! I think someone someone was sick, unfortunately. Hope they got better.
Modest
was sick. Okay. Hope it's doing better. And so next week I would try again because they got Degent and Lav, and that was very interesting to hear them. So yeah. Yeah, I'm going to make it. Okay, I'm trying. I'm going to try tomorrow also to get into this space with Polaris. We will see. Yeah. We'll see. It's crazy because there is so much content, so many spaces happening. Today there was a WoW space community. I was able to listen a bit. It's like every day I have something. It's so much stuff happening the whole time. And we're in a bear market. So like what's going to happen? I don't know, in 1 year. Or to when we go back to the bull market, I don't know when, but when it will happen, it's going to be crazy.
So that's the craziest part for me, is like trying to like figure out time for everything right now, Netta. I don't know if you're having like the same, like for me, it's like, I don't know, like which Discord, which project, what space am I listening to today, right? Like, what am I tapping into? Plus we got, what am I doing with the damn show, right? Like, what do we got going on? And so like, just that whole like, the flex and balance of time, you know, I don't know whether it's just the fall creeping up on me or what it is, you know, but I'm trying to fight the light as long as I can, like staying outside for as long as I can. But I don't know. It does seem like that. I was I signed into the Wizard Wednesday space yesterday, and Dota, LJ Truel, and Bear Snake were up there talking about what the future, they're fast running a whole entire fantasy franchise right now. Like they're speed running it and they're very conscious of that. And so when they do the game, the comic books, the show, like the way that they're trying to move through this as far as a project, you know, they were just speaking to the larger ethos and the challenges that come with that. Like they're not just trying to release a project, they're speed running a fantasy project to the front of, like Bear Snake has a plug with Titmouse Productions, which created Rick and Morty, which is involved with Netflix. Ooh. And so like trying to like build that bridge and get that going. They've got a lot of stuff cooking over there with the Wizards. Excited to see how this trick or treat event goes down. Oh shit. And then one piece of alpha they released on the space, right? Cause it's always important to give the alpha if nothing else. So in the last boxes, they released boxes last year, right? Some merch boxes that you could buy. And in some of those boxes, they actually had like a little ticket for a pony. You could win a forgotten pony. I didn't know that, right? For the merch box. They're giving out more merch boxes. They're going to have another merch item going out for Halloween this year. Forgotten Rune is. I got access to a merch box last year, but they were like $300. And I was fucking dead broke. So I was like, yeah, no, can't do this right now. Super sweet hoodies and shit. Just can't afford it for a candle and a hoodie out of my price range. Right. But like for this one, I think it was Dota ended up saying like, there are like, we're not saying that there's not digital goodies included in this box. Right. Or an opportunity for digital goodies. Hmm. Some of y'all may have heard that there were ponies in the last boxes. So, and then, LJ Truel was like, hey man, but like, what's up? Like, are we giving out a bunch of shit like digital goodies for trick or treat? Like, you don't think you're putting too much on your plate? And like, they were doing a little LARPing back and forth, you know, up on stage. And Dota's like, oh, I don't know. I don't know. I just hope we can figure it out. I hope we can figure it all out. We'll have to see. But like, whatever it is they got coming in the way of the merch boxes and for the trick or treat, some incredible opportunities to get some goodies for the larger community right now. So
And then, of course, for holders as well, the more that you're holding, the better your odds of getting a treat are. So for whatever that is, y'all, don't miss out on October 28th. It's going to go live, and it'll light up fast. So, but yeah, merch boxes dropping from Forgotten Ruins too. And then, I don't know if we're going to mention it, Netta, like, doesn't WoW have some new stuff opening up over there? You want that?
Yes, of course. There are two new projects. Maybe.
Before you get there, I wanted to just, the conversation we were having just before the wizard stuff about the content, where to place your time, all that stuff. Mm-hmm. I wanted to just give my piece on that as well, because it's something that I've been struggling with. I think during the summer, there was about two and a half months of like spaces every day, 4-hour spaces. I was on a lot of them, and it was it was a lot. And like, just emotionally, like physically, mentally, I think the pace was unsustainable for me. And so I had to really just pull away from it, because it wasn't just that it's the act of, you know, getting on a space and doing that. I think also just even the same educational spaces where it's like explaining the project, like first you do it on a Tuesday, then you do it on a Thursday, and then there was so much of it, and I was like, I've really pulled away from Twitter spaces, not forever, but just I'm more in the audience when I can jump in, like New Tokyo News, and I'll just hang out there and I'll listen in 10KTFM as well. I'll jump on after like I unwind from the damn live stream. Because yeah, it takes a lot from you, and I think especially as a creator as well, I have like I almost see it as like a balance of how much are you consuming and how much are you creating. And it's like, if I'm consuming, I have this nagging voice that's like, you could be creating. But when you consume as well, it also changes how you create and what you create, because that's the nature of, you know, being a human. And so for me, I'm pretty protective of like content, where it's like, even in NFTs, I didn't watch any of the other Nifty Alpha stuff or like any of like the rug radio spaces, not because I don't want to show up and support them, but for me it was like I have a unique perspective and a unique way to do content, and I'm still discovering that. And the more that I allow myself to be immersed in how other people are doing content, I'll see what they're doing, and then I'll start to mimic them, and I'll start to like try to be like them rather than bring my own unique content, which could be rough right now. I think given enough time and enough repetitions, it does, you know, refine. And so like for me, I really treat it as like art. Whatever I do at Digital University, whatever my threads are, whatever content videos that I make, I look at it like art, where I'm like, this is an expression of Atare. That's like the primary motive for me. It's like looking at my pieces like art. That's why even I'm so adamant on sticking with like my pseudonym, because it's not just my pseudonym, it's my stage name, or it's my artist name, like Atare. That's really, I really view myself as like an artist rather than like I don't know, influencer or content creator or whatever. And so for me, there's like some rules that I've set up that I like to abide by, because I feel like it'll let me unearth what it is I'm trying to do in this space more. So that's what I wanted to share about my creative process. But maybe please tell us about WoW.
Nemo, you wanted to add something?
No, I mean, it's very similar to what Atari just said, like the, you know, the winding down, the plugging into spaces, trying to be in the audience. You know, normally I'm always jumping up on stage, but no, same thing. I've managed to like to be a listener in an audience, doesn't take quite as much engagement and allows me to still be productive in other places, right? And so I think that's a great point. You know, we'll wind down from this and then I'll jump on 10KTFM. But by the end of all it, by the time 10KTF closes, I'm like, turn to my wife and I'm like, I've been talking for 7 hours straight. Like I need a bong hit and a glass of water real quick, you know, for whatever it is. Right. And it's about being conscious of that. Right. Not that we have to. Right. But, it's part of the moment. Right. Early on in the days when I used to do 12, 16-hour days in 10KTF, this is a much healthier balance, much more sustainable balance for me. And I think, you know, we'll all do well to keep that in mind going forward. But no, I want to hear about what's going on with WoW real quick. And then we need to touch base about Son. We know we got soulbinding going on with Son too. So I want to give them a little plug and go over that real quick.
Yeah, so with WoW, there's a lot going on. Actually, there's a couple of community projects that just got launched recently, like in the last couple of days. And then there is the WoW Awards that were launched by the team I don't know, like they asked to nominate yourself, and I haven't done it because I feel so I don't feel good doing it. I feel super bad. So I don't know if no one nominates me, I'm not gonna be.
What do you I got my pen out. What are you trying to get nominated for, fam? You know, I got you. What's up?
I'm already gonna, yeah, I'm gonna nominate, and if you beat me to a diamond, then I'll vote for that.
No, hey, if Regina doesn't take home the whole damn award ceremony, it's rigged. I'm serious. JF.
I don't know why. It feels
Regina for everything, or it's rigged, or we're going to riot. It's
rigged! Yeah.
This is not for the WoW, though. It's for the person. So
okay. So it's for maybe right. Neda. Maybe Neda.
Yeah, maybe for everything, no, or we riot. Yeah.
And I'm not an artist. Just... So...
I was going to ask the audience, who's going to be there in New York, Miami, for Art Basel? Who's going to be there from the audience? Is anybody coming to Art Basel? Because the Dam is going to be there. We're going to be hopefully trying to get some tickets for the Dam Gala. Not the Dam Gala. The WoW Gala.
For the Dam, yeah. For the Dam WoW. Yeah, I think now I think we're going to make it with the tickets. I don't know. I'm very positive about that. And yeah, the thing that I'm scared the most is the dress and the shoes. So
me too. I'm so worried about the dress.
I don't know. Sorry, guys. But yeah, I know it's silly. But still, when I think about it, I'm like, what's next year? It's... December, beginning of December, knows.
I think he's saying he's gonna come next year, or he has the date wrong.
Hey, so Jade's WoW kind of looks like her. Should I have her try to do cosplay for the gala, or is that not the right event for that?
Oh, you know, I mean, I feel like it could be a look.
The dress is good, like the dress that you chose for her. On the WoW G it fits. It's the green one. It's like, yeah,
butterfly on the shoulder right here. Yeah, we'll find a little something to stitch in there. Yeah, I'm just saying, yeah. I think it could be fly cosplay, but we haven't figured out what we're gonna wear yet too, but that's our highest stress right now for sure.
Okay, so going back to WoW and the community activations. So we got two this week that I would like to show you. Let me just share my Twitter. Okay, so the first one is WoW storytelling. So if you are a creative writer, or like you want to, I don't know, help, like anything you want to do with your WoW or the WoW universe in general, and you want to contribute with that, they just launched WoW storytelling I believe it's gonna be some kind of outlet for all artists and creators, especially writers. And yeah, you can get your stories showcased in a newsletter. I think there is so many new other activations that are gonna come in the future. There is, like, this is a little bit reductive what they write in this thread. There's gonna be so much more coming from this. But if you're a creative writer and you wanna write about WoW or anything World of Women, you can just participate in this. I don't think it's only for all holders, to be honest. I'm pretty sure it's for anyone, but you can find more information on the WoW Twitter. And then there is another thing that I'm super proud of, which is here. Where is it? here. Humans, wow. So Buck, Mitoshi, and Chrono, they just started Humans of WoW. There's a little spoiler here. I hope they're not gonna hate me for that. I could be, or maybe not, in one of the on the future episodes of Humans of WoW. So they're gonna just like this is a it's gonna be a visual content. And they're going to do interviews and bring on community members. The scope is like to create, like to talk about stories in the community and people in the community and what they do behind the scenes. Like if they want to talk about their life, whatever they want to talk about. If they're artists, what's their art? If they're not artists, anything they would like to talk about. Just to show interest in the... in the people that are part of the community, besides just the PFPs or NFT space. So it goes much deeper than what we see on Twitter right now, that it's sometimes it's very superficial. So this is going to be a much deeper story of the people that will be part of this. And yeah, I'm super happy because I know all of them, obviously, the founders of this. So we have Mitoshi, Chrono, and Bok, and they're all amazing. I can't wait to see their content. Just to say, Chrono has been working with Netflix in the past. Like we're talking about people that really, really have wow. knowledge and they know what they're doing. So I'm expecting something very, very cool from this.
Wow, that's amazing. Thank you, Maybe. And while you were highlighting all of the amazing initiatives that WoW was doing, I went on 10K Friends and I found a little countdown timer.
Oh. Okay, so it's
6:45. 6:45, exactly. 6:45.
I have a question. I hope it's not a stupid question, but can I claim with my warm wallet?
I think everyone, you have to claim with the original wallet.
No. No, I hate it.
Yeah. You have to. Because I think it's the ape coin sits at the wallet level. So it reads the wallet address that you have connected and then says, here is your claim. Mark is saying you can do it with Worm. Okay, we shall see. We shall see. It would, to be honest, it would make sense that they would allow that. But when I connected last time, mm-hmm. when it was showing, like on Battletown, I had my warm wallet and then my cold wallet, and both of them had a certain allocation of ape. So I'll see if when I claim with my warm that's connected with through warm, I'll see if I can get it all together.
What I know is that when I enter in Battletown with my warm, I get the notification about the ape coin.
Okay.
Which is a good sign, in my opinion. But at the same time, it is still not a confirmation that I will be able to use it.
Yeah, because for me, I had my ape claim still split across two wallets that I saw on Battletown. So we shall see. We shall see.
Okay, so Diamond, you had something to talk about with the sun?
Yes, Diamond.
Yeah,
soul take bind. It away.
About to get this thing soul bind up in here real quick. Go over, we know Son, Kaku, Crow, I Am Complex, the amazing team over there, been working hard, right? All these traits, y'all, all the characters, what we've seen to date. I had the chance, before I was listening to the Wizard Wednesday, Son hosted an amazing space yesterday, just going through what their vision for the project into the future is. Shout out Press. Press got up there, asked some amazing questions. Bobby was in the house. Brensois, you know, all the OGs, all the legends are up in there supporting. But I just wanted to kind of ask y'all, like, go over this whole minting process, how the soul binding might work. Share screen real quick with you so we can talk about the cost, because for the first 3 days right now, we're being given the opportunity to get a little bit of a discount on our stuff, right? So for the first soulbound discounts, levels 1, 2, and 3 will receive discounts of 0.367 ETH, right? So for the citizen, even though it's normally 0.7, for the first 3 days, it only costs 0.33. 1 year of Salon platform access, the Genesis hardware, the earbuds that are being constructed, and 3 years of event access. And then for the Defiant, that's being knocked down to 0.633 ETH from 1 ETH. And as you can see, it comes with a larger list of perks there. One musician invite. So once they open up the streaming platform, if you've got a homie or you yourself do a podcast, you make music, they did say podcasts and audiobook. They're going to look into opening that up as a separate a separate system. So we're going to do on the streaming system for songs, because the nature of listening to podcasts is a lot more like it's longer terst. You're going to tune in for long term. It's not shuffling through tracks or getting necessarily like how many listens your track got. It'll be like time listening over time, because the listen to earn aspect on the Salon platform, y'all, is going to be very important in what they're doing. You know, it's not an accident that they're already listed as the number one Billboard NFT music project right now to date. For whatever that is, you know, with, like I've been saying, in a little bit of an ETH crunch right now, right? So I'm looking at the citizen, but I'm like, I'm aching for that Defiant. I don't think that I'll make it to the Hanzoku. There for the 0.963, which comes with lifetime platform access and lifetime VIP line to in real life events. Because we know Kaku hosts big events already in the underground DJ world. Mm-hmm. And then who they're going to continue to bring in from there. It's not an accident that Kaku reached out to DL from Apple, from Beats. You know, he's the golden ear in one of the highest levels of the music industry. So with whatever they're doing, we can pretty much be assured that it's going to be top tier quality. And then for the 3-3, for 5 ETH, and that's like 10 toes down, right? If you're really down for the cause, special musician invites, special access, special Genesis hardware, 100 user invites, 7 plus 7 for all in real life events, and a Salon Sound Government's token airdrop. So like if you're 10 toes down, that 5 ETH is the way that to really hold it down. But that's also a significant cost investment, you know? And when we talk about, you know, it's not all about return on value or whatever it is. I think there's just some considerations to kind of have there. So I'm going to shut down the old screen share there. But yeah, just wanted to kind of bring up a conversation, like what are y'all thinking about your soul binds, and which one of your Salon NFTs are you going to soul bind? I sold my lobster yesterday. I got a rare rug and like pulled a rare lobster out of my mints, and then went and bought a diamond hand. They got the diamond hand character, so I had to go in and get one of those, and I'm definitely soul binding that diamond hand thing, you know.
And Diamond, speak of the devil, because as we were talking about that, San just tweeted out 3 minutes ago that soul binding opens at 7 Pacific time today. So that is 7 Pacific is 10 p.m. Eastern for the Eastern folk. Mm-hmm. So it's time. It'll be the first 3 days from today until that's Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So I think Saturday is when the discounts will end. Yeah, honestly, I'm still thinking about which one. It's definitely going to be for me the one of the red ones. I think my red tank is what I'm going to soul bind. I just need to decide which one, which level that I want to go with. Likely, it might be Defiant, but I'm looking at Hanzoku and I'm like, I just haven't done like the math on like what makes the most sense for me. So that's what I'm looking at.
Okay. Wow. I wasn't expecting it to be happening today. I haven't been following this craziness. So let's go with the stupid questions first. So if I just hold my NFTs, but I don't do this, it's like useless. It's zero utility.
I don't know. Diamond, do you know?
to my understanding, yes, like if you just choose to hold it and not soul bind it, you're still getting, like, you got a piece of free crow art, right? Like the initial mint, if you ended up paying for it on secondary. But like the thing about the first 3 days is that little bit of a discount that they're giving out to like try to encourage folks to get those initial numbers rolling. And so there is the 0.367 ETH discount that if you're going to apply in the first 3 days, will save you some money, Netta. But once again, something to consider in the long term, you're still going to be able to soul bind later on, right? So if you need to hustle up some ETH or wait for the price to fall, maybe hopefully not too far, but whatever it is, you can take your time with that and enter later as well. They're not going to shut down the soul binds. So there will always be that opportunity, to my understanding.
Okay. So let's say that I can soul bind only one with my finances. Let's put it like that. Doesn't even make sense to keep the other sand that I have or just sell the rest?
I mean, I took it into consideration for myself. Like, I'm about these earbuds, right? Like, I do want these earbuds. And so, like, for me right now, that's my initial entry level of utility. But if I had the extras, that's kind of why I flipped my Lobstar back, right? The Lobstar was dope. Had, like, the little rocket on the keyboard. Super rare. Like, it felt rare. And they listed a whole, like, list of traits, y'all. If you haven't been to the Son Sound Medium, there's a whole, like, for what they're doing with traits and specialties, y'all, rarities within that. So each level of every single trait could hold its own rarity within side itself, not just into the larger PFP, right? But the way that they've built, you know, I heard Crow say yesterday, you know, like, it's not that we don't want to, you know, what is it? He's saying, like, you know, like, I get what it is. Like, we're not just going to give out this initial mint and then not have opportunities for folks coming up later, right? Like, I know what it is to mint out a one-on-one in a collection and be like, oh, fucking awesome, I can go pay my rent now, you know, or whatever it is. Like, there's value that gets added through additional long-term collection as well, right? So just something to keep in mind, Netta, that like they're recognizing that value gets added along the long term. And so like for whatever that is, I sold my Lobstar back so I could get a little bit of money to put into the soul bind itself. I'm in a real tight situation with my ETH, you know? And I think that's kind of where it lies. Like, up to you, you know, at the same time, if you could go long with those, I think there's additional considerations for the future. Even for folks that don't end up soul binding, you know, Crow's not one to just forget about people, you know, knowing the fire he's walked through. He's got a big heart on him and really sees the larger picture, still understanding it's a market, right? And we got to provide value for the folks who entered the market for that purpose. But some people are just here for the art, and we're not going to forget about them or either, is the way that I really felt on that Sans Sound space yesterday. So for what it is, kind of a decision to be made for each person there. But personally, I did sell mine back, Netta.
Okay. Yeah, because I'm thinking about that. Maybe sell. I have four, so maybe sell some of the others to raise some ETH to do this, because I really, really like Kaku's music. Like, I really, if there's an event, I want to be able to get in, you know? So
yeah, me too.
Like, I think it's gonna be super fun, and I really want to go. So yeah, it's always the real life events that
have me. You have one with a key? You have one with a key on it, Netta? Do you have one with a key?
I don't know.
You get backstage access at every IRL event. Ooh. If you have a key on your, anywhere on either your NFTs, if you've got a key on it, it's backstage access at all IRL events. Like, they're adding so many cool layers of utility to this into the future. And like Crow said yesterday, they're not, like, they've built in the initial settings now, but that's going to continue to expand into the future. So just some really cool stuff. If you haven't got the rarity sheet, definitely peek into that before you let anything go, Netta, for sure.
Thank you. Okay.
So 2 minutes and this 2 minutes. 1 minute. Yeah.
And I want
time.
I want to clean with worm. I want to clean with worm, please. I don't want to go take my ledger out. Oh.
I don't want to know. So, Noah's had a good question. Silly question. What are the chances of Kagami being soulbound? I honestly could see it. Remember, 10KTF had the original soulbind with the map that was soulbound to the wallet that everybody opened up. So
yeah.
I could see it being soulbound if you claim the physical, simply because it solves the problem of, like, what do I do with my NFT? Like, after I claim the physical, does that have any utility left? And so if that's what they want, if they want the people that claim to keep the actual NFT and the physical together as a set, soulbind. I could see it. But yeah, they would have to obviously let us know if that's the case. They're pretty hush-hush on all of these things. And so I can imagine it's not going to be a surprise if they're going to, you know, make it soulbind. They're going to let us know how the dynamics of it's going to work. And if there's any, you know, other utility beyond just it being an art piece. And yeah, Zayla, Tinder hot date app is sponsoring us. You know,
what's going on today?
You know, that's when you know you're starting to make it, is when the bots start to hit you with the messages on live stream. So I see it as a sign that we're on the right path.
Wag me.
And Ape Claim is live in 3, 2, 1. We have liftoff. Oh, okay. So it looks like you can do it with Worm. Look at the new UI. Look at the new UI. Beauty.
Yes.
So it shows your Worm wallet and your Hot wallet. So if you didn't use Worm for some of the missions and then you consolidate everything, now you can claim all in one.
Let's go payday.
I swear I thought I had more than 90. Those bastards.
I don't know. When we get
more than 90.
I like to always write payday and feel like
payday. And payday.
Do you have the radio on? Like can you turn on the radio on Discord now, Ataru?
I can do that. Correcto. Let me go to
because,
it.
Because Midori and Juri are rolling. What else can I say? Radio is going ham. Let's go. It's payday and it's Friday. No, it's Thursday.
Can you guys hear it or no?
I can't hear it. Try it.
We'll have to do it the old-fashioned way today by sharing the Discord.
Claiming. We're claiming live right now, baby. Let's go.
Did you claim Diamond?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You're all really 138. Okay. All 130 of them, thanks.
Account for deposit. Okay, deposit thanks, in this one. $4 in gas.
Oh my god.
This is what you're giving me right now. Let's go. Claiming.
Hey, y'all, my side chat on the right side. My side chat says looks like your embed link is invalid. And like I just gotta tell y'all, like when you can't see the actual chat on the side, like you do notice that you're missing out on something. You know, so not that I'm tripping. I'm just saying, like, it's just immersive experience. I'm only half immersed right now, for what it's worth.
Congrats, everyone, on your claim.
Yes.
Congrats, everyone. Let's take the win today.
Get your money.
Get your payday.
Get your payday on.
I successfully claimed. Yes.
Great. Can you guys hear it now or no?
No.
Really? I thought you guys could.
Okay, so $700. Okay. What my son is giving. News. Blame your ape. Perfect. Please hold for Kagami sale update. What do you think it means? That Kagami is not going live in 10 minutes?
Yeah, looks like it.
Congrats, William! Thank you, Anthony.
Shit, yeah.
Still nothing on music or no?
Yeah, yeah, we can hear it. It's just a bit
loud.
Like, but this is, I'm liking it. Okay. Like this.
Fuck it. Keep it. Okay. I saw you dancing and I'm like, there's no way you're dancing to nothing. You have to hear it.
I'm dancing when Midori is the DJ. Let's go, Midori.
Hey, and then we got a Louis 200 drop going on too. I don't know if y'all remember the last Louis 200 drop, but it coincided. Beeple had a box in there, right? A trunk, as far as they were calling it. Not that we're super connected to Louis Vuitton, but just something that, along the larger ethos, the collection into We New Labs. There is the Louis Vuitton We New Labs partnership. The 200 trunks, 200 visionaries. The Louis 200 was a part of the collection that 10KTF was a part of. So something to keep an eye on.
Okay.
Did I say 10KTF was a part of? Sorry, the Trunks Beeple was a part of, not 10KTF. That's what I said. My bad.
Well, during the Mark Patterson, no. During the Twitter space with Carl, Atari was the one that actually asked the question to people about the space. So that was cool to see. Today he tweeted about it, and I can't wait to go. Like, I just can't wait. I'm gonna be there opening day. I'm there. I don't care. Whenever that day, I'm gonna be there.
Yeah. Same. Also, let's just get our disclaimers out the way because we just claimed some ape. In case of investigation by any federal entity or similar, I do not have any involvement with this group or with people in it. I don't know how I am here, probably added by a third party. I do not support any actions by members of this group. I'm now safe. I'm safe. Fuck you, SEC.
Hey, isn't it just, whatever, let's not dive too far into that. It's just getting weird out here right now. That's all I'm saying. Just getting weird. That's it. We're gonna keep partying.
It's getting a little crazy.
Yeah, so, this is how I'm doing it today. I got my Team Atari mug, pouring the water up. You know what I'm saying?
Speaking of
my
water.
My Netta in the other hand, they're both full of water. I'm just out here sipping on both.
Water.
All of us.
You guys all have mugs. I have nothing. I need some water. I'm going to be right back. Bobby, we love you. Shout out to Bobby Kessinger. We love you.
Thank you, Bobby. Dance. And your tweet was so sweet today with the damn coffee, Captain.
Yes, we hope you enjoy it.
Yeah, and thank you and Polaris for putting on that enclave space y'all are doing too. Big time stuff, appreciate you.
I'll be right back. I'm gonna get some water.
I don't think Ace has that many ape right now, to be honest. I don't know exactly how many it's costing, but I don't know if he has that many.
Right on with the radio.
That was, they are intentionally glitching that, huh? You're right, Netta.
Yeah. Let me just show them. Let me show this button. Thank you, shopkeeper.
Crazy Crypto Carl, man, too. You gotta look into that. Too much going on.
What about Carl?
Crazy Crypto Carl's minting. I think they took a snapshot yesterday or the day before. They'll be going to mint for CT Nomos for Crypto Cats by Nomos. That'll be happening in the next couple days. If not, I don't know, if not today, tomorrow, I think.
There is no, because I was waiting for it. I thought I was going to be able to mint like yesterday. But I didn't understand. They said that the details on the mint are going to be. Oh my God, we got Tinder again. Stop it.
It's going to be a few days. Huh?
But can we just block them? I blocked them.
I've been like sliding this chain the whole time, getting that energy going, you know.
Oh, really? Docking?
Trying to break the damn thing, huh? You guys are trying to break the damn thing.
Breaking the chain.
No yelling on the bus.
Yeah, Anthony, this is Midori. On this board.
Sugoi, huh? I guess Saturday is Sugoi, huh? The same.
Susan, I'm laughing about that as well. I don't know if we're going to be able to mint. Seems like there's a delay or something.
Yeah, that's what it looks like. Why is there always the delay? Team.
Wagnison's number one rule is patience. Netta showed me that today. Reminded me one time. Yeah. Thank you, Netta.
I like this background, by the way, Atari. Look how good the logo looks. I can't hear you.
It's funny you say that. Because I was thinking the exact same thing.
Stop it.
I'm not even joking. I was literally thinking the exact same thing. And speaking of patience, I've been so damn patient and I can't take it anymore. I can't take it anymore. I want my Kagami.
Yeah, it's not happening at 7 p.m., I think. You have to wait. But, like, the fact that I got Ape in my wallet, it really put me in a in a good state. Peace state. Thank you. I don't feel worthless today. I got ape, so
it's payday.
Payday.
To be honest, I think I kind of got screwed. Not screwed. That's being dramatic. Because I got less ape than what I thought I was getting based on what I saw on the website. I think. I could be wrong. I'm gonna confirm.
I got the exact same, so yeah, double check.
Hey, mine's still pending right now. My safe transfer's on the way, but I know it's gonna make it to me. Just a matter of time.
Mine was pretty fast.
Yeah, my gnomes are all messed up over here right now.
Very strange. I was supposed to get 113, but I only got 90.
That's weird.
I'm gonna open up a support ticket. Hideki, I'm coming.
Get ready, Hideki.
I'm coming for you. I want my ape. We're gonna get.
Yeah. 10K friends hasn't updated. They might be getting a ticket from me too.
I got taxed.
I got taxed.
The tax man coming for everybody.
No, it didn't come for me. I got exactly the right amount.
So there's we pay your taxes.
I paid my taxes already.
No, we paid for your taxes.
You paid for my taxes, and thank you for that. Yes, I accept it.
This is the perfect
I appreciate music. It.
Hideki, I'm here for you. Hideaki.
Oh yeah, Tari's got the. Hey, what sweater? Is that a Kugi sweater? Like, what is that? Is that Balenciaga? That's a fucking nice sweater you got on today, friend. Damn, bro.
It was all a joke. Kagamis do not exist. We will never meet them. So we have been fighting on each other for 5 days.
For nothing. I was saying,
like, I'm really going to the throat for nothing.
Yeah. We were, I'm seeing the party animal himself, Van Buren, later tonight. So I got to get my party vibes ready tonight. So I'm rocking it's a nice sweater.
It's so jelly.
It's a Nike skateboarding sweater. I love it. Ooh.
It's a hottie. One of my favorites. I'll tell you that right now. It's an absolute hottie.
Hey. Hey.
So say hello to the legend Van Buren from us.
Of course. Yes. I'm seeing Nano as well.
Nano. Hey. Yeah, I met him as well in Miami. First time. Hey. We went to the zoo. Yes, I got them too. No, yeah, I don't know. I don't have the bear. I have only the ballerina.
Didi Rock with the ballerina. And Nana was like, yeah, no, there's a Didi Rock from Miami. Like this girl, homegirl that I know does all this badass art. So I'm out here just plugging her while I'm here. I was like, let's
go. You know, I went to her studio.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, I met her and I went to her studio in Miami. She showed me where she actually makes art, and it was amazing. Like, I had so much, like, I really can't wait to go back to Miami, because last time I went to Miami, I really, really enjoyed it. I met so many NFT people and artists, and Nano, it was so, so nice that he made me meet even Didi Rock. So yeah, no, it's a cool vibe. There is a lot of art going on, a lot of, you know, from women, minorities, a lot of stuff going on in Miami. So I can't wait to go. And you will love it, Diamond. I can't wait to see you there. These NFTs are making you travel, eh?
Art Basel in itself is already pretty nuts to me, right? Like, that's like, I've always dreamed of going to Art Basel, but now, like, NFTs gives me a reason to head out there, right? Damn show. Kicking it with the homies at the dam. We're going to head out there and sit shaking, you know? But I'm hyped about it myself. We're going to take a whole day on Friday and just kind of hang out in Miami. And then my wife's sister lives, I think, somewhere up north of Miami there, Fort Lauderdale or something like that. So we'll go visit her for a day and then get back over to the West Coast.
Nice. Let's go, Midori.
Let it win. I just dropped the fat ticket on Hideaki. Hideaki.
Good thing you said ticket, bro. Like, he dropped a fat. Oh no, he's not gonna say a deuce. He's not gonna. Oh, okay.
Yeah, it looks like there is no minting live of Kagami's.
Yeah, I don't think he's coming.
Fucking rug.
We got rug.
Kind of. All right. Yes.
So until when is? Yeah. Yeah, I guess we cannot mint on the damn live. So we will have to mint privately. Our Kagami's, we'll see. But yeah.
We'll see when it comes out. Maybe it happens on Saturday. Maybe it happens in the
No, hour. I think it's gonna be today, just later, like 1-2 hours, I would say.
Agreed.
All right.
I don't think they're gonna change date.
Oh, Irina left such a nice message earlier when we were talking about the Kagami stuff. We love you, Irina.
Irina?
In the Dan channel.
Irina. We love Irina.
She said she's loving the honesty right now.
Let me put it.
Thank you, Snowman. Thank you for joining us. I love that cat token as your PFP. Swilson, you enjoy that smoke, Nunk. I'm sorry you're coping, but sometimes you gotta cope to get through things. And Matt the Vulture, it's Melbourne time. I'm sorry you have to go through this rug, but we appreciate you, Matt, and everything that you do. Fake Eye, good night.
Good night.
This was the damn live. Everybody, as the song fades out, we're also gonna see you one last time. Have a good night, everybody, and take care. Hug your loved ones and smile on, because Kagami's are coming for some. Good night.
We love Thank you. You so
good night, Katie.
Jesus.
Love you, William.